on you, man. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of
You want a cold beer?
Start the show.
Yeah. It's cold beer for you.
Please.
Yeah. Gotta have beer, it's Tuesday night, right? Son of a bitch. Well, don't give me a warm one.
We'll put it in the fridge.
Oh, yeah. Make it cold. Absolutely. Yeah. So anyway, here
you
we
know
are.
What I've noticed about these shirts, and I hate doing this because I harp too much on the fact that I'm gaining weight on the air. But the damn logo is so far down that it makes me look fatter, like my big fucking gut stretches it all the way down.
You're so self-conscious about
listen, Mr. Hat, let me fucking brush my teeth before... Don't tell me I'm self-conscious,
but
you are
you're
too.
You're not fat. You know what I'm saying?
No. The shirt looks pulled down. Look at the camera.
You're not fat.
The logo's supposed to be like right here. It looks like it's way down there.
You're not fat though.
You
mean,
you can't really tell.
You go out in public, and you see America, half of America,
yeah.
And they're fat.
Here's the problem.
You're not fat.
You've got this thing where your brain isn't as smart as your eyes, or did I say that backwards? Your eyes are smarter than your brain's smarter than your eyes. Your eyes are smarter than your brain.
Yeah.
Actually, no, they would both be dumb in this scenario. Because you see me every day for 2 years, and I moved here, I weighed like 150.
And now you weigh...
Probably 200 pounds. We haven't stepped on a scale in forever, but...
200's not fat.
I've gained 50 pounds.
It's still not fat.
Did I say fat? I said now that I'm gaining weight.
You've been saying you're fat every week. You come out here every single. I'm getting fat.
Do you know the reverse? You know the reverse psychology. You make fun of yourself, and nobody can make fun of you.
All right, you're fat.
Yeah.
Look at you.
Fucking enormous.
Look at you.
See how it works?
You fat fuck.
Yeah.
You.
I was gonna
fat
say now.
Fuck.
I was gonna teach him what reverse psychology is. Now that I say I'm enormous, you don't want to make fun of me anymore, do you? And he says, "You big fat fucking.
You big
blobby
fat greasy slimy fat fuck."
All right, let's do a show.
Listen, it
Baldy.
Is hot.
Yeah, it is hot.
I'm sweating. Can we try to turn the AC on? Because this is not gonna work.
You're not gonna get an argument from me on that one.
It's
hit the button.
Hazy. It's hot. It's humid out. I warned you. I warned you ahead of time. I said, look at you with the remote. Yeah, buddy.
All right. Remote control AC.
I said to you, I said, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday.
Guys,
week,
real quick. Let us know in the chat. I'm sorry, in the middle of your thing.
Yes.
Because we just turned it off. Let us know in the chat if it fucks the audio up, the air conditioner. We'll turn it off. We'll just sweat.
I said Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. It is going to be hot. I mean.
You said humid. Yeah, you said it's going to get increasingly humid as the week.
It wouldn't be so bad. 90 degrees outside. Wouldn't be so bad, but then you add the humidity in there,
and
it's
stuffy and gross.
Dude,
yeah.
It feels like it's 130 degrees. It feels like you're in a freaking oven.
Well, I was telling
out there, you know.
Yeah. Well, I was telling you earlier. What's great is he makes more money than me. A little bit more. Not as much now that he lost Jared Barker, but a little bit more. We talked about all this on the air. Now this is new news.
I was having a terrible month, by the way.
Yeah.
And we're ending it on a bang.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing.
Well, what's great is, not great, it would be great if we all made a lot of money, but every time you're like down, I'm up.
Yeah.
And then when you're up, I'm down.
Yeah, I know.
When I first moved here, you were damn near rich, and I was at the lowest point of my life, so. But, what was I going to say? Now I just threw myself off.
I don't know. Something about money.
Yeah.
And us being, well, I'm ending the,
what it was, the room thing. Yeah, like, you would think... The guy that makes the most money would have the master bedroom of the house. He doesn't. He's got the little closet next to me. I've got this giant fucking room with my own entrance to the bathroom. I got an air conditioner. He doesn't. I got this enormous room.
I sit
in a recliner when I work. He sits up in a fucking chair.
You know what it is?
It's crazy.
I don't like a big open space.
And it wasn't like I convinced him to do that. When I got here, he was already in there, and this room was empty.
No, but it's I don't like a big open space. My office that I have in there.
I got two windows.
It's,
he's got one.
It's compact.
Yeah.
You know, everything's
you feel like you're in a
box. And I've got my desk in there, and I understand that. My little office.
You do have a bitch in debt. He's got like an L-shaped desk, like he could do stuff over here, stuff over here.
I like that little. I like being in kind of my own cubby.
I understand.
My own,
when you're working, and
you know,
that's all we do, really.
I like being in
so,
there.
So yeah, it feels like you're in an office. I get that.
So anyway, God, it has been. You said it wasn't earlier today, but
it's been busy, man.
It's
not
been
that
non.
Busy. Most Tuesdays, I will come on here and say, yeah, it's nuts today. Today it was. It was normal. It wasn't busy. It was a normal day at work.
May have like a record amount of Facebook posts today.
Maybe you were behind and you were catching up or something.
So, this is what we're going to do.
What are we doing?
List Thursday.
We shouldn't have the computer right on the screwed up part of the cord, and it shorts it out.
So, last Thursday we came on here. We weren't able to do a show on Tuesday with the Ustream issue.
Right.
So, last Thursday we came on here, and I said to you, Payback has already passed. It was way back on Sunday, and Raw has already passed. It was way back on Monday, and we're getting to Thursday, right? So, we did Payback, and then Monday Night Raw, we did it really, really quick on Thursday night.
Yeah.
And there was a guy, Jay, that I just saw. There was a message up on my Facebook that said, I think we need a format change or something. Raw, you guys run down every segment, every single week, segment by segment, Monday Night Raw. I don't like doing that because everybody that watches this show has seen Raw from last night. So I like the idea of doing the big stuff and some of the backstage segments.
Right.
And then we can spend more time on rapid fire and phone calls.
Yes.
Because I think that's what these guys want. People in the chat room, they always say you rush through rapid fire. It's rapid fire.
Yeah,
that's why we do it.
Kind of the name of the segment.
But more time for phone calls.
That's funny the way you heard that.
More time.
It is named rapid fire.
More time for phone calls and more time for the rapid fire segment, so we can get to more of the news as everybody's seen Raw from the previous night.
Should be up here, man. Why is it all the way? Look at this. This is the logo.
I think that's what we're gonna do from now on. Just kind of fly through Monday Night Raw, do the high points, the low points, make it quick, and then talk news, rumors, and things like that. We had a great UFC 187,
amazing,
from this past weekend that I want to spend a little bit of time.
That was gonna be my response to what you were
Andre
saying.
Arlovski and
Travis Brown.
Oh man,
pop up. Yeah, it was insane. But yeah, it used to be my show. Everybody knows that. And when it was my show, I focused more on interviews. We did a whole second hour on MMA. Like, hour one was wrestling, hour two was MMA. Like, I really tried to find the comfortable balance, and you get the feedback, and people like this, they don't like that. But what you can't do is focus too much on the feedback, because it's like 1% of the people watching.
And one person wants this, another person wants this.
That's what I'm getting to. It's only 1% of the audience, and even in that 1%, they're so divided on what they like. So
right.
What you got to do is stay true to what you think is entertaining, like Stern.
Right.
If you think it's interesting, talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
And the audience will find you.
But
you don't
that's
try and craft your show for the audience you have, because everybody likes different shit.
That's another thing, is at the end of the show, every single week.
Like the Jackie thing last week.
At the end of the show, every single week, we tell you guys, the last thing we say before we end this show, every Tuesday night or Thursday night last week, is we want your feedback.
I haven't been posting the feedback.
How can they submit feedback? Well, I go and I put the feedback post up last week, and I get two comments on the feedback. So
total?
And then two comments total, which is like a record low for last week. And then the following week, people say, well, I think we need this to change, or don't do this. But y'all don't put that in the feedback, that when we go off the air, you got to submit feedback, because we're not doing this thing for you and I.
No.
We're doing it for you guys. So, when we do the feedback
I
thing.
I do it for you and them.
When we do the feedback thing, don't be afraid to say, yo, your show sucked tonight. It was terrible. I'm not going to ban you. I'm not going to block you. That's what I want.
Or you got to listen to them?
If something sucked, there's a guy, Jay Mullen. I think Jay Mullen.
That sounds right.
Is that you?
I was gonna say Mullen when you said Jay.
Had said you gotta shorten. You gotta shorten
a cherry.
The.
Come on, bro. Oh, damn.
You gotta shorten the. I see it.
You gotta shorten the
Raw recap. So I said this week that's what we're gonna do. So we're listening to the people, but we need more of your feedback. So
when they bitch about the weather on my feedback page, you don't pay attention to that at all.
I'm gonna talk about the weather, whether people are like it.
Yeah,
or
I was gonna say that's where
I've talked about the weather in weeks, except for
it's not winter anymore.
It was hazy hot.
What are you gonna do?
We talked
about
that a couple minutes
like,
ago.
There's nothing to talk about. It's hot. The end. When it's snowing, you like to say, "Oh, the clouds are moving in at this speed, and they're gonna dump this many inches, and it'll go away at this time, and start at this time." There's a lot more to analyze there. And you're the only one who pays attention. Literally.
So listen, let's get these plugs out of the way, and then we'll get into it. We'll talk Monday Night Raw from last night, and then we'll get into some of the news and the rumors. The TNA, Impact Wrestling, the cancellation reports, a lot that we need to talk about there. Pretty much what we said on Thursday, nothing has really changed, but something irks me, man. Somebody put something up on my Facebook page today, and there's been a lot of things. We put up a big exclusive report, I think it was Sunday night on the website we put it up, and a lot of people, you know, you want TNA to die, and you know, none of this is true, this, that, and the other thing. So we're going to talk about that and give you the latest on TNA Impact Wrestling, what the deal is with Destination America, Ring of Honor. I'll tell you what, real quick, Ring of Honor announced a match today for New York City. Ready for this? Samoa Joe and AJ Styles against Frankie Kazarian and Christopher Daniels. How about that?
And it's a TV taping.
How about that?
Not a live event. It's a TV taping.
I don't think it is.
I guarantee it's a post-pay-per-view TV taping. So you're telling me the night after the pay-per-view, they're taping a bunch of TV. That match is part of the taping.
Okay.
I wrote the story. I know it.
So they're taping TV from New York City.
Yes.
From New York City. All right.
It's from something 5. The Terminal 5.
Terminal 5.
Yeah, yeah.
All right. That's TV taping? Yes. I didn't know that. All right. No doubt. That'll be cool.
New York, awesome.
New York City crowd, Terminal 5. They used to run in the Manhattan Center, the Hammerstein Ballroom, but the prices to rent the building had increased so much that they went over to
Terminal
5.
See, now, what happens is, Jim Ross, this is how I know for sure I'm right, because Jim Ross mentioned it in his blog, and he got all fucking big rant about, he's so fascinated that Samoa Joe's contract with WWE is this big story.
No, he wasn't fascinated.
Why is it this big story? No, he said, understand. Right. Why is it this big story? Blah, blah. What he doesn't understand.
It is a big story.
Yeah. When you sell a newspaper, you don't know what people are buying it to read. With a website, you can see how many people view this article, how many people view this article, how many people view this article. So the fans dictate what's a big story, because if they're viewing the shit out of it, you want to try and give them updates, because obviously it's something they're interested in. The Samoa Joe thing's been one of the most viewed posts for the last several weeks, the details on his contract. So it's not, because he's criticizing the media. And it's like, dude, the internet media is different than the print media or the TV or radio media, because we can tell you exactly what people are looking at. And if they're looking at something way more than something else, obviously that's what they're interested in, so we try and feed them it. So it's not the media making a decision to make his contract this big story. It's the fans are obviously interested in it, because that's the one they're clicking the most, so when, we give them updates.
When has a guy, I mean, let's be honest here, when has a guy from the indie scene come into WWE, and the first thing they do when they get there is, number one, sign them to an exclusive deal, an exclusive contract, where they say...
Sometimes they'll let you finish up shit you've already got on the book.
You finish up your current dates, but Samoa Joe
is taking bookings.
New dates. Mm-hmm. So that's number one. They sign you to an exclusive NXT deal or a WWE deal. Number two, they change your name. You don't come into WWE with the same indie name. Very rarely. There's been a couple... Don't get me wrong, but
very select people come in. How that works is when they come in developmental, higher-ups have no fucking, they don't care, run developmental, whatever.
All right.
Paul Heyman was running OVW, I think it was at the time, or Florida FCW, whatever, I think it was OVW at the time, and CM Punk came in, and he let him be CM Punk, and he was shouting to management, this is somebody you need to call up,
right?
And by the time that they were calling him up, he was so established that it was like, well, we can't change this whole thing, called him up for the revival of ECW,
right?
So they didn't care about that either, so they just kind of let him do his thing. And I think with the Samoa Joe thing, it's Vince McMahon. It's like, yeah, Triple H, run NXT, give me some future,
Do your thing.
Yeah,
right,
so Triple H is like, well, everybody knows Samoa Joe. We can't bring him in and call him, you know, Bing Rappington or something. Right. You know what I mean? You gotta... And they even have the music is the same.
Everybody knew Prince Devitt. Everybody knew Kenta.
Not as much. These are overseas stars. Samoa Joe was famous in America.
Kevin Steen
was an interesting one, but he wasn't... As you think Kevin Steen's as big of a name as Samoa Joe?
Although Sasha Banks, they didn't change her name.
Where did she come in from the indie scene? Okay,
She came in from the indie scene. They didn't change her.
Well, there's plenty of examples, but it is rare.
Right. Charlotte, well, she was Ashley Flair, and she wasn't working many many indie promotions. Ashley Flair, right. But she wasn't working many indie promotions, I don't think.
Yo, let's see how big of a wrestling fan, an old school wrestling fan, Mr. Brian Clark is.
I'm not an old school wrestling fan.
Why is her name Charlotte?
Oh, come on, dude.
It's an easy question.
Of course it's an easy.
What?
Ric Flair, the Nature Boy, her father, Charlotte. Charlotte, North Carolina.
Nothing.
He was a legend.
It seemed obvious, but it was one of those where, like, I bet he doesn't
get it. Come on, man.
Hey, Florida?
Hey, that's stupid.
Florida means Florida? The five-knuckle shuffle means jerking off? What?
All right.
Yeah, there's examples, bro.
All right. Get out of here. Anyways, all right. So, if I didn't get that one,
that would have been bad.
I'm not a fan. Yeah. I'm not a fan.
You would have lost credibility.
Right. So anyway, here we go. We'll get these plugs out of the way. We'll talk Monday Night Raw from last night. That match in...
Her name was Mercedes KV. So
oh, is that what it was? All right, they did... Mercedes KV?
Fucking Rygal knows everything. How does he know all this shit?
He's good with the indie scene.
He's a big indie fan.
He's good with the indie scene.
That's what it is.
Mercedes KV.
He lives in New York City, right? Manhattan, somewhere in there?
I think so.
He's, like, in the city part, not upstate.
Right.
Yeah, so he's probably around for all these shows.
Mercedes KV, I remember that name from the indie scene. Not
I don't.
Not a big indie star, though, right? Mercedes
I've never heard of their name, so it couldn't have been that big.
I've heard of Mercedes KV, but yeah, they changed her name.
There's a porn star I jerk off to named Mercedes, but not KV. What's KV stand for?
I don't know.
Probably her real name's like Katie Vick or something. Yeah.
Katie Vick.
First KV that came to mind.
Alright, so here we go. Let's get these plugs out of the way, and then we'll get into Monday Night Raw from last night's backstage news and rumors. Talk about TNA Impact Wrestling, the latest on their deal with Destination America. Talk a little bit of UFC 187 from this past Saturday night. The official home, the official website of WZR TV Tuesdays, WZRonline.com. We are on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube as well. Go to Facebook.com/WZR Army, YouTube.com/WZR Archive. We're on Twitter as well. All you got to do to find the links to all of those social media outlets is go to WZRonline.com. Top navigation bar. It's got a drop-down menu, social media tab. It's got all the links to Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. WZRonline.com, the official home of WZR TV Tuesdays. A live chat room on In Progress. Lots and lots of people in there. As always, tonight, you can get there by going to www.wzronline.com.
.com/chat.
WZRonline.com/chat. Lots and lots of people in there, as always, tonight. Get in the chat room. Taking your questions. We're taking your comments out of the live chat room. WZRonline.com/chat. All right. Monday Night Raw from last night. Top to bottom. Overall.
Yeah. You do this every time. You should do it at the end. I don't remember. We'll have to go through it for me to remember.
It was... Nah,
which
yeah, you
weird,
got...
cover it. I should remember it like crazy.
You've got Elimination Chamber. I guess it's the go-home show to Elimination Chamber. The thing with this, by the way...
Yeah, I don't remember
did
anything.
You hear that Charter is buying Time Warner Cable? It's a big deal.
I don't even know what Charter is,
deal.
But no, I didn't know they were buying
that's
Time Warner.
That's a big deal in the cable world. There was a couple of months ago, actually for about the past year, there's been talks that Comcast and Time Warner Cable were going to merge.
Like AOL Time Warner did.
And that is a huge deal. I mean, as far as American cable networks, I would say Time Warner and Comcast.
Those are the two.
One and two.
Yeah.
You know,
I've lived all over the East Coast. Those are the only two I can think of.
I want to say Time Warner's number one and Comcast is number two, but I may be wrong on that. It may be Comcast is number one, Time Warner's number two.
They're the top two.
Either way, they're the top two. Number three?
I think.
Number three?
Yeah, what is three?
It's probably going to be Dish.
Dish Network? Is that a cable provider or a satellite company?
That's satellite,
yeah.
But I think, yeah, you're right. Well, then if we exclude satellite, I would say Charter is probably number three.
No, I've never even heard of Charter. There's another one that I've heard
Charter's
of.
Charter's a big company, man.
There's another one I've heard of, like not Cox Cable, but there's like another
there's
one.
Cox,
I've
heard. There's
go to
Cox.
The chat. They're probably throwing names out all over the place, and we're not looking at them.
DirecTV, but that's satellite, right? I think is DirecTV satellite. I think DirecTV and
Dish, yeah.
And Dish. I think they're satellite, but the top right, three...
Eagles fan says he just read three is Charter, so...
Is Charter... Charter's up there, man. Yeah.
TNA fan says he thought DirecTV was number one. We're not counting DirecTV or Dish.
We're not doing DirecTV or Dish because they're satellite, but I would say Time Warner or Comcast is one and two, and then I think Charter's number three as far as just cable companies are concerned, but Charter is buying Time Warner Cable, and they value.
Where do they got all the money to buy out Time Warner?
Take a guess at how much they value Time Warner Cable.
$350 million.
$350 million.
Yeah.
$70 billion.
Oh, billion! If you were gonna say million, I'm gonna be like, wow.
Billion okay. Yeah, right. Dollars, dude.
Sure.
$70 billion.
Bro, it's at least half of the country. That's how they watch TV.
That's
and
crazy.
Most people's whole lives are just sitting on a couch watching TV.
I heard that on the news today that they value Time Warner at $70 billion. So this is a big merger. They say that your cable bills aren't going to increase right now, but you know what happens in a year or two from now where they've got a monopoly and they can charge you whatever they want.
Well, that
and your bills
Warner,
start going up.
Comcast. What are they? $70 billion for Comcast or Time Warner?
Time Warner.
Yeah, Time Warner merged with AOL. Remember WCW lost their fucking bank?
Time Warner and AOL merged a long time ago.
And there was another merger before that or after that, and it was another big-ass merger.
Right.
So they're like all these different companies rolled into one. It's not just cable. They do all kinds of shit.
They provide internet,
they provide cable, they provide, you know.
I mean, we've got, I know a lot of you guys listening probably have either Time Warner or Charter Cable. And they're going to
Comcast. Where I came from in Florida was Comcast.
Right. But anyways, that's a big deal. So anyway, I don't know how we got sidetracked there. But so Monday Night Raw, right?
What even started that?
I don't know.
All right.
I don't know. So the entire show pretty much was built around Dean Ambrose was supposed to sign a contract.
Now I remember the show. Okay.
Dean Ambrose was supposed to sign a contract
to face...
To face Seth Rollins at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view. So that's kind of how they started the show, and
part of the middle was that
where he was arrested.
The camera on accident.
Right. So, alright, so the show kicked off. You had, I thought for sure, now listen, you had a great Memorial Day video package.
A little bit long, but
the entire show could be dedicated to people that
lose
their lives.
Well, there was a lot of angles.
And by the way, Memorial Day was yesterday, and I know there's a lot of people that read the websites and that even listen to us on Tuesday nights that you guys are over there right now, some of you guys that are fighting for us.
Could you imagine that? Jesus
people are losing their lives, and why are they losing their lives? Because they're defending our countrymen. It's awesome,
crazy.
Can
you imagine volunteering to go kill people? Oh, God.
Anybody in the Army, in the military, in the Navy.
The size of crack cokes.
Wherever you guys are, man. The Navy, the Army, the
Air Force.
Air Force. Yeah. All of them, man. You guys, like Boone said, you're awesome, man. So, thank you guys for...
We're not going to make it our whole gimmick like John Cena, but it is awesome what they do.
Good transition. As I thought for sure. That last night they do the video package. Mr. America himself, especially. You want to keep it on?
I'll keep it on. I'm starting to feel fine now. So
yeah, but
thinking
second,
about money.
The second we shut it off.
Yeah.
It's been on for 2 hours. Right. I thought for sure.
Here. I turn on 5 minutes, dude. Come on, man.
Fuck you, man. Alright, so anyway, but I thought for sure, over the last couple of weeks, I'm here, and he's been facing Rusev, right? So he's Mr. America for months. He's Mr. America, dude, da-da-da-da-da, I represent the United States, da-da-da-da. I figured, Memorial Day, American holiday, John Cena's coming out, and here's his standard promo that we've seen week after week after week. All you United States,
great fans.
Right.
You know where I stole that from?
You didn't think Cena was coming out first?
I didn't because they. That's what I was saying. There's a lot of angles going on at Raw last night. It was Memorial Day. It was the Memorial Day show.
Right.
Last show ever at Nassau Coliseum, which is like MSG of the, you know, the other part of New York. The Elimination Chamber go-home show. Like, there was a lot of different things, and they had to cover it. And so I thought, well, if he's already got his match with Owens, he's got to do a U.S. Open Challenge. We knew he was doing one of those.
Right.
And I didn't know how they were going to do the angle with Owens and have him do a match against somebody else.
Yeah.
Without, like, all right, we'll do one of them in the beginning of the show. And the end. They did them, like, right at the same
time. Well, I thought the opening segment to get Kevin Owens over, what better segment to put Kevin Owens, a guy that you're trying to get over.
Yeah, I remember you telling me you thought they were going to start the show.
What
with
better
all this?
Segment yeah. to have Owens in than the opening segment or the main event?
Well,
one of those two segments is where
it
you want
to. It
should
have been obvious that it wasn't going to happen. And for the same reason I told you last night, the Authority kicks off Raw every fucking week, no
they
matter
do.
What's going
they
on.
They cut that 20-minute promo
that
every
Behold the King week. Of Kings, on your knees, punk. Blah, blah. That's every fucking week, 8
yeah.
o'clock. On your knees, punk.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every week.
Every week.
No matter what the big angle is, they start the show, they end the show.
You always get that 20-minute opening promo.
It's funny, man. Like, everybody says,
Rollins
Triple H isn't a performer. Blow me. He's the fucking the performer of the show every week. Well, because he doesn't wrestle every week?
To kick it off, yeah. right? So anyway, so the Authority comes out. I mean, you're talking the whole Authority.
Oh,
you have Triple H, Stephanie McMahon, Jamie Noble, Joey
Kane,
Mercury,
Seth
Rollins, Kane.
Yeah.
yeah, I'm all out there,
all
right? And,
tell you something right now, Ryan Clark. I take care of him looking in, man.
He is awesome.
He's so
bro.
Great.
I fucking love Noble, dude.
He's
Noble
good.
Is awesome. But anyway, it was basically Rollins said that Dean Ambrose made the decision to give Ambrose the shot at the WWE, or he's made the decision to give Dean Ambrose a shot at the WWE World Heavyweight title.
So there's a much quicker way to do
Seth
it.
Seth Rollins
the whole
decided to give.
The whole 20 minutes was, we need you to sign a contract if you want the match.
We need you to sign a contract.
That was it.
That was it.
And then it just killed time for 20 minutes.
Pretty much.
That was the whole point of it.
Pretty much.
That was it.
And
they
Ambrose
said a lot of stuff, but none of it meant anything.
So Ambrose got the ringside, and Roman Reigns comes out.
Yes.
Or Ambrose never came out, right?
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
He came out, and then Roman Reigns
yes.
ended up coming
and
out.
And they kept him out there for a tag match that they went straight to.
Right. And so Stephanie McMahon, to end the segment, Stephanie McMahon basically said that Dean Ambrose had until the end of the night
that,
to sign that contract for the Elimination
that,
Chamber.
And that was this Sunday, but let's talk about tonight, and then that's when they introduced the tag match. Stay out here.
That was the tag team
match
with Dean Ambrose and Roman Reigns against
Seth Rollins
and Kane.
Yeah.
Right. And then we'll kind of end. That, like you said, was up next, right?
Yeah.
Go to
and they went to break. Two commercials for that match.
Two commercials. Yeah. Right. So
during the entrance, during the match.
Come back from the break, and that match starts. Like Boone said, they go to a commercial break, and what was the end of that?
I don't remember.
That was the cameraman, right?
That was backstage.
Yeah.
So Superman punched into a flying elbow from Ambrose, leading to a Rollins save.
Sorry.
Ambrose pinned Rollins, it said, but you just went past
we forget. Sorry, guys.
Yeah.
But anyway, so that was the opening segment of the match. They gave that right there, took up the first 20 minutes was the promo segment, and then the next 15 or 20 minutes was the tag team match. Itself, right?
And then we go backstage with Ambrose and JJ Security. By the time we're done with all that, we finally are about
You're
an hour through the show.
Through the first hour, right?
Pretty much.
I said to you last night, every time you see Renee Young,
and then the next 2 hours took forever.
Let me ask you something. How do I word this where you're not going to be like, oh, you homo or something like that? But let's say
talking
that
about Renee Young. Why
let's say, listen, you.
Oh, every time it's him and Ambrose.
This is going to sound terrible, but let's say you and I, you and I are dating, okay, you're a girl, or I'm a girl, you're the dude, okay, I'll be the girl, you and I are dating.
There wasn't
and
another example you
Renee Young.
We get enough gay shit as it is. You
we do.
Pretend we're a couple. I'm the bottom, you're the top. Motherfucker, you couldn't have...
Just
guy A and guy B are
just
a couple.
Go, just one
you
with
have
it.
Said that?
Everybody knows that we're
douchebag.
Not homo. Everybody knows we're not gay.
Come on, man.
Your
story.
But anyways... So Renee Young and Dean Ambrose are backstage, right? They're dating in real life, right? So I'm Renee Young and you're Dean Ambrose, and I gotta interview you, right?
It's probably awkward.
And you're Dean Ambrose, and he's making these. Well, I'm gonna do this.
How do you not laugh at him?
He's got the mean face.
What are you getting to?
And you're a real life couple, right? You're a real life couple, and you're like, I have a hard time not laughing. Like, yeah, you're my girlfriend, well, and you're my boyfriend. You know what I mean?
In that example,
something like that.
Renee Young is so goddamn professional.
She's not. Yeah.
No, she's so that's an obvious. And you don't even need to say. But right. She's so good at it, at the job of interviewing and talking. And like when she does the pre-show, she's got to pretend to be excited about this match.
Right.
This
she's
dumb thing.
So good.
She's so fucking good that it wouldn't even cross my mind. Like, why is she not laughing at him? Now, if she was like JoJo or fucking, you know, Terry Runnels. Remember when she was a backstage interviewer?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Right.
But, she was hot, kind of, when I was younger, and she always had a fucked up face and shit.
I met her in Albany.
I seen her in person once. I was on an aisle seat at a house. She walked by me.
She was hot.
She came up to, like, basically where the logo of the shirt
She was tiny. Yeah.
I love tiny little hot chicks. Yeah. She was so fucking hot in person.
But don't you...
Like, Sasha Banks on TV, her face is kind of
Right.
In person in Albany the other week.
She was hot.
I'd have thrown down just, $15 for some pussy.
It's just $15.
The joke I had to make something funny out of it.
But they say she was.
I'd have thrown down
ratchet,
$350.
Ratchet.
Wretched.
Wretched.
Yeah.
Wretched.
Disgusting.
Anyways. But anyways, so it's just all right. They travel in a car from arena to arena. They're having sex, they're making out, this, that, and the other. And then they've got to go face-to-face in a storyline angle on WWE television. It's got to be a little bit weird where Renee Young's got to keep this straight, professional face where Dean Ambrose
You're
is
looking
making
too
these...
Much into it. You're looking too much into it.
I don't know, dude.
They were both doing it before they hooked up.
True.
So obviously it's not like any different now.
All right. See, it's ratchet. Everybody's saying ratchet. I've been saying ratchet for weeks, but he says wretched.
Oh, no, I thought you were saying wretched or something. Like
no, ratchet.
What the fuck is this ratchet?
Ratchet means, like, you're a hoe. You're ratchet. You're a hoe bag. You're a slut.
Ratchet means hoe?
You're ratchet. You're
Someone tell me what ratchet means in a chat.
You look like a whore. Right. You look like a whore. You look like a hoe. Ratchet. You're ratchet. You're nasty.
Use it in a sentence.
You look ratchet.
No. You gotta make the word be.
You're ratchet. It's like a gangster street word where you look like a whore, you look like a slut, you're ratchet.
Wow,
you're
I know all the lingo and
you're
shit.
You're nasty.
I've never
you're
heard
nasty.
Of ratchet. That's you're, what wretched means.
No, ratchet. It's not wretched.
No,
ratchet.
Ratchet does mean nasty and ugly shit. But
it's like shady and hoey.
Yeah, that's
it's
what
like Rango
says, isn't it? All
you're
right.
Ratchet.
I've never heard of that in my life.
I've never heard of wretched.
You've never heard of... Wretched's a word, man. Ratchet's some kind of bullshit lingo somebody came up with. Wretched is disgusting,
wretched?
Gross.
No,
ugh,
that's... I
fucking
think,
wretched. It smells wretched in here.
I think you're mistaking wretched and ratchet.
I'm not.
Ratchet.
I know what wretched means. Stop it.
Somebody
but I've never
Googled,
heard of ratchet.
Somebody Googled wretched.
Yeah, W-R, and then I think it's E-T-C-H-E-D. I don't fucking know how to spell it, but it's wretched.
I think you're...
Ratchet,
I
never heard of.
I think you're confusing wretched and ratchet.
I promise you I'm not.
I think you are.
Someone in the chat, let him know that wretched's a word and it has the meaning.
Wretched?
Ratchet?
Ratchet?
I'll
or
give you.
Ratchet.
I've never heard of it. I've never heard of ratchet.
I don't know, man.
Ratchet?
I've never heard of wretched.
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 It's a word.
I don't think it is.
I'll show you on during the break. Wretched is a word. Clark, Boone is right. There you go. Thank you, Rygel.
Well,
he's the guy
right.
who told us it was
right.
ratchet, not
so,
wretched.
So do wretched?
Thank you.
Do wretched...
Sounds like they mean the same thing.
They mean the same thing. That's what I'm asking.
Yeah.
Do ratchet and wretched mean the same thing?
Where the fuck did ratchet come from? I've never heard of the word ratchet.
Ratchet.
Everybody's confirming that wretched's the word, but I've never heard of ratchet.
Wretched's with
sounds
a W.
Sounds like you're trying to say racket.
Wretched's with a
I
W.
I said
W-R-E-T-C-H-E-T. Oh, you did say W? All right.
Door to tape, man.
All right. No doubt. not denying it.
All
right. All right. So let's get back to Raw. We had... Rusev, oh Jesus!
Wow,
our good friend Jackie.
Not yet.
Our good
maybe
friend.
Maybe one. I'll open him up. But our good, been kind of spotty today. So
our good friend Jackie's going to be calling up here in our numero dos. She's not happy. She was on my
she
Twitter feed.
She probably felt like retching when she saw the Rusev segment last night. She was pretty sick. Like why?
No, that's Ralphing.
Up.
Ralphing.
Oh, there's a billion ones you could use there.
You Ralph.
There's a billion.
Ralph,
dude. Fucking vomit.
All right, so anyway, we had Rusev defeated R-Truth via tap out. This didn't go longer than like a minute, dude. This
was
quick.
It was quick, yeah.
It was really quick. We had, post-match, Rusev got on the microphone, and he wants Lana.
That's when the whole angle thing.
This is where it started, right?
Yeah,
and then they went backstage. So,
No, she came out.
she winds up coming out here, right? There was something later
in
the show.
And they
kind of teased
making up. I think she even kissed him. They teased the whole, like, oh, we're cool again.
He
said, all I need you to do is apologize.
Wanted her to apologize, and she's refusing to apologize.
Yeah.
Why? Because in Russian, at payback, he said, I quit. And she's not going to lie. She's not going to come out here and lie and say that he didn't say, I quit. That's what he said. I'm not apologizing. I was right.
No, it was more that he was being condescending, talking down to her.
Talking down to her.
Did you know what condescending meant? Sometimes I throw in the definition after the word in case he doesn't get it. In case you guys don't get it, that's what I meant to say. Sorry, it was a typo with the mouth.
But, is that what it was?
But anyways,
Continue on.
She was pissed that he was talking down to her, and that's what made her turn. And then, yeah, she would bring up stuff like, no, you quit, and I just said what you said. Like, that wasn't why she was doing it. The reason why she had that sudden change of thing was, all right, we're cool. Now, all I need you to do is apologize to me in front of everyone.
And that's what
what
ended it. Right.
Yeah. I'm a high kid. I don't apologize.
As she's walking to the back, I said, you watch, man. She's going to walk up the ramp, and Dolph Ziggler's music is going to hit. He's going to come out, and they're going to wind up.
And I'll put you over on this one. I said, no, dude. That was last week.
Yeah.
They're moving on.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, that's the storyline, but they're not going to go straight to the same thing again. He was right.
She came
right out, they made out.
She walked up the ramp.
You called it right on the money.
She was walking up the ramp, Dolph Ziggler's music hit, and
he came right out, made out with her, and they
made out real quick, and Ziggler kind of gave Rusev a smirk.
Yeah, rubbed
in
his
down
face
in the ring, rubbed in his face.
Take that, you wretched bastard. You know?
I got your girl, and that was that. Rusev's in the ring, left off pissed off.
Oh,
what else? Ryback defeated King Barrett.
Is
don't
anything
need to talk
worse
much
in the
about
world
that.
Than warm beer?
Warm beer,
it's pretty fucking gross, man.
I got some Coleman's here.
Especially
Coleman?
Warm, cheap beer.
Yeah.
Oh, it's already open. I got to drink on that a little bit.
I got Coleman's over here, man. We had,
in the fridge now.
Ryback defeated King Barrett. We had Neville defeated Stardust. Stardust did the angle with the actor.
Stephen Amell.
Right.
I don't know the name of the actor or the name of the show, but I wrote it, so.
We had the Entourage crew, which we'll get to here in
I have watched a little bit. I watched every episode.
Have you? Yeah.
Like, three times.
Actually, they were
just
backstage.
Just recently to watch the movie that's coming out.
They were backstage with the Divas. This is where Zack Ryder came in, right?
Yes.
And there was something that Ryder had to do tonight.
Well, it was a little midget Kevin Connolly. I guess he's from Long Island, that area.
Right.
Where I guess Uniondale.
Zack Ryder and Zack
well,
Ryder Long Island.
Well, last night, but they were calling it Long Island.
Right,
so I guess
right,
Uniondale
right.
and Long Island's kind of an interchangeable.
Right. So Ryder basically said there was something he had to do tonight, right? Because
it was Connolly saying, yeah, you're from Long Island, you're the Long Island Ice Z, what the fuck, all those things.
Right.
And then they got distracted by the Divas, because that's what all the other guys were worried about.
Right.
Yeah.
Last time the Nassau Coliseum tonight.
They really used the characters the same way that they're used on the show. Like, Turtle would stick his foot in his mouth, say something stupid in front of
Right.
Or be, you know, like, they all left.
So I don't watch the show, so I don't know.
It made sense. Connolly's usually a nice guy that isn't so concerned about pussy, and everybody's like, your girl's hot, why ain't she the, she's cool. You know.
Yeah.
That kind of, so they kept all the characters pretty much how they were. Like, and Kevin Dillon, the he was kind of a douche. Like, it was pretty good.
Alright.
They used him good. They used him, it was a rare celebrity guest host.
Right.
That was kind of used properly.
Alright.
Like, it was all cool, like, as far as a wrestling fan, and if you know the show, it kind of fit in there, too.
Kind of fit in.
Yeah.
We had Sheamus defeated Dolph Ziggler. Sheamus won with a brogue kick. Rusev was out there to distract Dolph Ziggler in this one.
I don't remember that.
Yeah.
Did he beat him down afterwards or something?
He did. They got after Rusev
in the accolade, while Lana looked right at him. Rusev screamed at Lana.
Right.
Basically telling her it was all Ziggler's fault that he suffered.
Cena comes out to a pretty. They didn't like Cena last night. They didn't like Cena.
Listen,
so
New York's fucking Long Island, New York. You think they're gonna cheer John Cena?
And that was his whole promo last night. Was you know some of you guys cheer me, some of you guys.
I think WWE expected it. They after a while. I mean, God.
In New York, they know what's gonna happen.
After 15 years, they kind of know which cities he gets kind of cheered, kind of booed, and so they give him an opponent. Zack Ryder, the hometown guy, they must have known the crowd's not going to like Cena, so let's give them somebody to cheer.
And they're smart, man. They're in New York. They're in Long Island. They know that they're in the Northeast.
Yes.
Cena doesn't get cheered loudly in the Northeast, right?
And he's from the Northeast. He's from Boston.
Cena's cut. Yeah, but he always, even in Boston,
I know.
So anyway, eventually you've seen us cutting this promo. The Entourage crew comes out. They're walking out in the ring, and they say, hey, we've got somebody.
That was the Zack Ryder thing we were talking about backstage.
He's going to accept your U.S. Open challenge, and it's a guy. It's from right here in
Radio.
It's a guy that's right here in Long Island, New York, and out comes Zack Ryder. Whatever it was.
We used to play it on the pre-show.
Cena defeated Zack Ryder.
The sweet I like the...
It sounds just like it.
You're making a fool out of yourself. Cena defeated Zack Ryder.
I thought that was really cool.
Retained the U.S. title in about 3 or 4 minutes. It didn't go very long here.
No.
Tamina defeated Paige. I like the fact that they're doing more with the Divas division, even on the main roster. I know that down in NXT, well, they brought Tamina back. They've got Paige. They've got the Bella Twins.
Tamina was out.
There's actual storylines. There's actual storylines now on Raw. And although they had Brie Bella, Stephanie McMahon, over the last couple of months, they've been doing more.
You don't think so? NXT, they clearly do. In WWE, they got a 3-hour show. They've got a roster of about 20, 25 divas, and they put two of them on a 3-hour show every week. That's it.
You're right.
Unless they're a manager like Lana or...
All right, so you can say that there's only one Divas match on the entire show.
Usually they try and cram like 20 Divas in there, even if they're at ringside, to put them on TV.
You're right with that, but at least they've got a storyline.
They are solid. It used to be meaningless matches they would just throw in the ring.
And they throw them out
there.
And now
they try and give them a thing.
There's some sort of storyline that's going on, even on Raw. Now in NXT, the Divas, I mean, we were at NXT in Albany.
We had two Divas matches.
And one of them
was the second hottest match on the show.
Right, and Sasha the crowd was all over them, clapping and everything else. But the fact that, you know, they had this whole give Divas a chance
movement,
that whole thing.
Campaign,
so the fact that they're at least giving the Divas a chance. With meaningful storylines that culminate on pay-per-views, you know, it's a step in the right direction.
They've always tried that, but it seems like they're trying to put a little more into this, like, let's
a
make
little
it,
more focus, emphasis.
I think it kind of started with the Brie Bella Stephanie thing at SummerSlam.
I agree.
So over. It was the main event of one of the Raws. It was like one of the semi or third from the tops.
Who
the
takes
pay-per-view.
Credit for that?
Of course. Of course. The last name is McMahon.
Right.
But, I think that was the motivation for it, and then, what we heard earlier this week was that Triple H and Stephanie, basically because of Ronda Rousey's popularity, are like, no, it's a different era, like, girls can be tough badasses and still be over and cool, and so let's try and change the way we use our divas, and I think that's what you're seeing is a little of that influence.
Speaking of Ronda Rousey,
Vince doesn't agree with it, supposedly.
Speaking of Ronda Rousey, she had some comments the other day.
It was the Wall Street Journal thing, is that what you're talking about?
Talking about where she basically said,
would you really want to know if I'm coming back?
Done with WWE, whole thing?
She basically said...
You wrote it down.
She teased a surprise return. She said, what... It was a Q&A... hosted by the Wall Street Journal in Los Angeles. I think it was yesterday. I think. It might have been over the weekend. But basically, it was so some fans asked a question. And one of the fans brought up the WWE rumors. Dana said, you're never doing it again.
Is that true?
Can you confirm to us so we can stop hoping for it? Blah, blah, blah. And she said, well, listen.
I think the quote, but before you go on, I think the quote that I have, maybe
you're mixed up
in
different interview, I think.
It may be two different interviews, but the quote that I have is,
a lot.
She said that, there is no chance that you have seen...
That's a different one.
All right, well, there is no chance that you have seen the last of me in WWE. So, that's her basically saying, I'm coming back.
She never said that. She said something about when she was backstage...
I quoted it.
A legend gave her advice and said, you're never really done with this business, although you could pretty much guarantee that I'll be back someday, I just don't know when. But I think the quote was it won't be for a very, very long time.
I didn't hear that.
Well, you can Google it. I know I'm right on that one.
I quoted it. You guys saw it in the title. I quoted her actual quote.
Yeah.
It was right in the title. She says, there is no chance you have seen the last of me in WWE. Now, it may be a very, very long time from now.
She might have said that.
You may be right.
Followed up with the very, very thing.
Right.
Anyways, at the Wall Street Journal, that was the most revealing comment she's ever made, because the fan asked her, can we stop being excited, hoping that it's going to happen? Can you confirm that you're never doing it again?
Right.
And she basically said, well, listen, like, kind of like talking to him like like a shoot.
Right.
Like, what was the exciting part about WrestleMania? It wasn't that I was there. It was that nobody knew I was going to be there.
Right.
The Rock
right.
walked around the world. You know, she didn't say all this, but she
it
said,
was the surprise.
The surprise factor was what
surprise.
Made it.
Right.
It was what made it.
Right.
You know, what made it cool. And she said, so do you really want to know if I'm coming back? Like, really? Like, wouldn't that ruin it?
Right.
And then she went on to tell the same story about the legend, giving her advice about how you're never really done with this business. Once you get it in your system, it's always in there.
Right.
And then it was something to the effect of no chance towards the end. She said, after getting that, like, I grew up a fan, and after feeling that, like, there's no way I'm not going to do it again.
Right.
Something
right,
like
right.
that. And then,
something like
so,
that.
But basically, she made it sound like what she wants to happen is for the media to leave it alone.
Right.
Stop being a story. That way, when she does pop up, like, oh, shit, it's Dana. She even
when,
said, she even
when
said,
she pops
said,
up, you know it's going to be WrestleMania.
She even
you know?
Said, she even said, when she does pop up, she said the fans would probably be like, oh, shit, Dana said she was never allowed to do this, and here she is. Holy shit. Like, she wants to...
Yeah, when's it going to happen? On a Monday Night Raw?
No.
You know?
I mean, they wanted her for Hell in a Cell to do something small with Stephanie to build up to Mania.
Right.
I don't think that'll happen.
Right.
I know that's what they wanted in WWE, and I know UFC doesn't give a shit about what they want. You know?
Right. Anyways, we had the...
You enter on the keyboard.
Oh,
that's right.
The only other thing I was...
Look at
the
shift button, bro. Oh. You're on the wrong side. There you
my
go.
Bad.
You got it.
The only other thing that we had was New Day comes out, right? And it's New Day, that whole six-man tag team match that they had on Raw.
Yeah.
And then the main event, that was it. That was all that was left for Raw. But...
It shut off again.
Yeah. We're going to have to fix it during the break or something like that. But the New Day comes out, right? Same promo. Oh, Long Island, don't give up. Or
it's a New Day. Cut your hair.
Right. Yeah. Something like that. So they wound up. It's basically, it's going to be interesting. I got to say, Elimination Chamber coming up this Sunday. First time ever. Six teams.
Tag teams.
Or five teams?
I think
there's five chambers, right?
Don't know. Oh, wait, it was the same tag team match last night, only they'll all be in a cage. It was Los Matadores, New Day, Tyson Kidd, Cesaro. That distracted me.
We're not going to come back on that.
And there was two other teams, I think. I can't think. Oh,
I think it's five. I think it's five.
Yeah, I think it was
there's
five.
There's
I think five, it's
five chambers.
Is that how many chambers there are?
I think so.
So
then I think there's
got to be five. See, they're not going to have empty chambers. So, yeah.
So you had them last night. It was basically the match that we're going to... It's not going to happen. We'll set that up during the break when we come back. But it's basically the same match that we're going to see on Sunday in Elimination Chamber, except for it's going to be in the chamber.
Oh, it'll be a different match because they did it in like a minute last night. Yeah.
Well,
I mean, it was quick. For five tag teams,
you know what I'm talking about.
10 people, it was a quick match.
You know what I'm talking about. The same members.
Like those guys that were standing on the apron that never did anything.
You know what I'm talking about. The same members that are going to be in the chamber match coming up on Sunday.
Could you imagine that, though, if you're the guy, like, and they tell you, get your gear on, get ready, you're on at 10:13 p.m., you're going to stand on the apron, no one's going to tag you, you're not going to do anything, you're not going to say anything, you're going to stand there, the match will be over in 12 seconds, and then you come backstage, take a shower, you go home.
That's it. That's it.
You want to pay me to do that, I'll be a pro wrestler tomorrow, man.
So listen, the main event...
Tag team pro
the main event of Raw, right, is basically...
There wasn't one.
There wasn't a main event.
Segment.
Earlier in the night, and we skipped over this, Dean Ambrose had gotten arrested.
Well,
explain that with the cameraman.
It was pretty basic. He was trying to go after what's their faces, and he had J&J Security, I think. Because I think Jamie Noble was
Jamie Noble came up.
Hey,
Jamie Noble
like
came up.
Down, like way down here.
Listen to me, you son of a bitch. I'll get over there, and you don't want to see what's going to happen next.
And then he started beating the shit out of J&J Security. The cameraman got a little too close for comfort. He got nailed.
Right.
It was obviously a wrestler, which you could tell while watching the show.
Now, later in the night, they showed right before the main event, the main event segment, they had shown security footage, which showed that Seth Rollins came up from behind Ambrose and pushed him into...
So it wasn't even... That's the true babyface heel thing. Oh, the guy that hurt the innocent guy was a bad guy, not the good guy. Good guy was an accident.
Exactly.
It was like 1980s. Let's make sure it's a good guy, bad guy.
It's revealed that Seth Rollins was the guy that pushed Dean Ambrose into the camera.
So anyways,
right?
Cameraman goes down, blah, blah, blah.
So anyways, they arrest Dean Ambrose, right? He's taken out of the building. So later in the night...
And it was weird, because it wasn't cops. It was like dudes in suits that had like a badge on their shirt.
We saw that. Was it when Stephanie McMahon got arrested with the Brie Bella thing?
Yes.
We had the guys in the suits.
Yeah,
it was basically like the same thing as that.
Yeah.
But so they come and they take him out and they arrest him, right? So as Seth Rollins is out there saying, or Triple H is out there basically saying, basically saying that, you know what, Dean Ambrose is going to be unable to compete. He's now in jail. It's not going to happen. So, with that being said, at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view, Seth Rollins will now face, and all of a sudden, they shoot backstage, and you've got Dean Ambrose who's coming in this police van, driving the police van.
Yeah, that's his gimmick. He goes in a car during a pay-per-view,
but wait a minute.
Back in the car.
I'm thinking, wait a minute. Is it legal to rob a police van? You know what I mean, dude? How did he get control of the police van, and aren't they going to arrest him for that?
He must have beat up the cop and broke loose. But
right, he must have kicked the cop's ass.
That's
so
the half-assed writing.
Does he have a warrant out for
no,
his
that's
arrest?
The half-assed writing. That happened. It's blatantly like, yo, he broke the law, he should be arrested. And it'll never be brought up.
It'll never be brought up again. No,
like,
no.
It never happened.
How did he get control of the police van? And how did he...
Well, I think that's how it's justified in the writer's room.
How did he get the
cap and the jacket? I think that's how it's justified in the writer's room. They're like, well, we never see him beat up the cops, so you can't... It's not like there's an open-ended
but
thing.
But any normal person is thinking, how the fuck did he get control? Well, actually, kids and whatnot. And
normal person, no. Kids, anybody that would have a brain, you know, except for really, really young people who wouldn't really know anything.
Here's the guy, Jericho Hulk. They released him.
Yeah.
So they release him to, and then...
Have you ever been arrested?
All right,
Jeremy,
all right,
they don't release you in a cop outfit
You're released. Go ahead.
Somebody's going to come pick you up.
You're released.
Yeah.
Here's the keys to our van.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
And here's a hat in case it's cold and a jacket.
Take it for a stroll, and we'll give you a hat, too. Go ahead.
Better bring it back.
Go on home, dude. Just drive our police van home.
No, I think in the writer's room, it gets justified because we never see him beat up the cop.
Right.
So... it can be justified. It's not like there's this loose end that needs to be tied up in the fans' minds because they didn't see anything. They just do that for effect, and oh, it's funny if he comes out in a cop hat. And I'm sure somebody had to bring up, well, wouldn't people be like, what the fuck, he drove a cop car and was wearing a uniform?
Jerkaholic, you're not getting it. They saw what happened, and they released him. That's cool. They saw what happened, they released him. Why is he driving a police van?
You know what?
Why is he driving the police van?
Oh, you're reading.
Why
me
does
up.
He have
okay.
a freaking
cop
hat on?
You know what else?
Why is he drive? Why isn't he driving? If they released him, why isn't he getting in his own car and driving back to the arena?
Ragnall just made a great fucking point. The guys that arrested him weren't even wearing cop uniforms. How the fuck did he get a hold of a cop uniform? They were in suits.
Yeah, how'd he get the cop
hat
uniform?
Come from? Where'd the jacket go? Where'd the car go?
They were in suits.
That's good.
So he comes back with a cop uniform.
Yeah, where'd that come from?
The guys that arrested him never had cop uniforms.
So it didn't even make sense in a comedic fashion. So it made no sense across the board.
No sense.
Like, he should have a warrant out for his arrest, A, if he fucking beat the cop up and took his uniform. B, the uniform, the cops that arrested him weren't wearing uniforms. Where the fuck did he get a uniform from? Like, it made no sense on any level. I didn't think of any of that stuff. Like,
I didn't either. I didn't think of
that. That's how WWE is programming your minds these days. You dismiss shit like that immediately because you know it doesn't mean shit.
The second he drove...
You know it means nothing, so you're not going to waste your time.
The second he drove the police back into the arena, I said, how the fuck did he get in possession of the policeman, number one?
Yeah.
Why does he have a police hat on? I didn't notice the uniform.
Well,
I didn't notice the uniform. You're right with that.
Here's how I know, because I didn't even see any of this shit. I didn't see the car, the hat, anything. I wrote play-by-play, blah, 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 and Ambrose is back, and he's, you know. Then today, the next day, today, I see pictures from Raw, and he's wearing this goofy, like, an old-school police hat.
Right.
And he's taking the jacket off and the hat off, and he's coming down to the ring. I didn't remember seeing any of that shit, so
stupid,
I must have been
man.
In the middle of typing, because...
Stupid. No, he came back. He drove the police van back
to
the arena.
Sense, but
came out, attacked Rollins, and then signed the contract, and that was that. And Raw goes off the air, and we've got our Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose match on for Sunday's Elimination Chamber pay-per-view.
Yeah, the big gangle there was, he's not going to be able to sign the contract because he's in jail.
Right.
So we don't have to defend the title against this scary, dangerous guy.
And well,
yes you do.
That's the whole thing. Triple H had said at that point, because Dean Ambrose is now in jail, he's not going to be able to face Seth Rollins at the pay-per-view, our new match for Elimination Chamber is Seth Rollins versus,
and then his music.
And that's where they shot
the cage. Or then the car freeze and
it came. Yeah. Right.
And it's so funny, too. Somebody, the old guy.
Look at that, buddy.
The huh? old guy.
Look at that.
We just ended the show. Right. The old guy in the chat says, and he brought it up, and I'll do it real quick.
The old guy. He's
no, that's his name. The old guy.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Parnell. My bad.
The old guy is what it's like. It's probably Parnell, and he changed his name to that. To fuck
that's
I guarantee you that's what it is. But, because, yeah, he made a big deal about it. But, anyways, he's comparing it to the Steve Austin character. Like, Ambrose is becoming his character that drives vehicles all the time. Remember he had the no holds barred or whatever that rule was at the
I kind of agree with that.
He left in a car with somebody, but yeah. He was the guy getting beat up, and then when he came back, he was driving the car, but threw the dude out the car, and
he is.
And then last night he comes in a cop car, and he busts out of a Christmas present. Or
not
Christmas.
Only that, but
he's becoming Austin.
He doesn't care about authority, yeah. Where he's totally against
Very
authority.
Very much like Steve Austin.
Yeah, he's right.
There's
he's
a
right.
big comparison there.
It is 9 o'clock Eastern
Parnelli.
Time on the Dizot.
Yes.
It is 9 o'clock Eastern Time. So, we are going to take a quick commercial break. See? This is how we do it. We get some news out of the way in hour one. We run down Raw. Now, all of hour number two, all of it,
is UFC.
Is news, rumors, UFC, rapid fire, phone calls. We got the entire second hour. All with you guys. Raw is done. Pay-per-views. There wasn't any this week, but everything is done.
It was UFC.
In hour numero uno. So, in hour numero dos, it's all about you guys. Rapid fire. How can they submit rapid fire questions?
For example, you go to facebook.com/RyanClark. That's facebook.com/RyanClark. WZR. Top post left for your questions and comments for the hour number two rapid fire segment. Once we return from the break, we'll answer them in a rapid fire style fashion, which means it'll be quick, guys. So if you want a long rapid fire segment, you better give us 80 questions, because we're going to answer them quick. That's the whole point. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. All right.
We will be back in hour numero dos, taking your live phone calls, taking your rapid fire questions, and your questions and comments out of the chat room. Speaking of our live chat room, you can get there.
Where?
WZRonline.com/chat. WZRonline.com/chat. You're listening.
I don't have Dean Ambrose.
For real?
Oh, there he is.
So WZR what are we TV Tuesdays with Matt Boone and Ryan Clark. We'll be back right after this.
Yes,
numero dos.
Yeah.
I'll be taking your rapid fire questions and your live phone calls as well. We'll give out the live phone number here in just a little bit. But we've got a rapid fire up at facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR, a live chat room on in progress. Lots and lots of people in there. As always, tonight, WZRonline.com/chat. Jacob will be here after the show goes off the air, if he is still awake. He always comes on for the post-show, cuts a promo, probably bring his potato beater. And
his new thing is, he likes to do the announcements.
Yeah.
The ladies and gentlemen, he gets about that much out, and then the rest is...
He's always on here on the post-show, as long as he's not sleeping, so if
but
you...
But his voice picks up towards the end, he'll go...
When we go off the air here, when we say goodbye to you guys, we always come back in about 2 or 3 minutes after we go off the air. We take the set down, so if for some reason you want to watch us take down the set and see Jacob and whatever else.
I'm usually not involved, so if you're looking for me, don't
you're usually in there doing your feedback, put up the feedback.
By the time I come in
like
here
that.
Is when we turn it off.
Right, right. So anyway, our numero dos is all about you guys. Live chat room questions, comments, rapid fire.
UFC.
Let's talk UFC. What we're going to do, we're going to open our number two up. We'll talk UFC first, and then I want to give you guys the latest on TNA, and I want to respond to a couple of people that have been on my Facebook page and on the comments section
you got a whole
as
speech?
Well. So, not a big speech. I haven't planned anything out.
Basically,
but
you need me to be quiet for like 3 minutes? When
if that's impossible for you to do, but no, yes,
if
you
tell
could.
Me beforehand, I got a rant. I just leave me,
if
let
you
me
could,
get
I got a little rant that I want to go on after UFC. So,
absolutely.
Speaking of UFC. We had UFC 187.
We did.
This past Saturday night, live on pay-per-view.
Yes. It was a great
run
show.
Run it down, baby.
I mean,
don't want to run the whole thing down. That's pointless. But
just do the top three.
Top three fights were, all of them were great. I mean, the main event, Cormier-Johnson was all right. Belfort Wyman was awesome.
Cormier and Johnson was... I expected more from that.
I did too. I
expected more from that.
Although, there was part of me that expected exactly that. Like, Cormier's like, I let me just you. Grab him and hold him and wrestle him. And
I think I beat you in bets this week here. It was
no,
close.
You had
it
Belfort. You
I had Belfort.
You had Arlovski.
I had Arlovski over Brown, and you were pretty sold on Travis Brown. You said it was a close fight. Absolutely. You said it was a close fight.
I didn't. You're giving me credit where I don't deserve it. I thought Arlovski was going to get fucking killed.
Yeah?
He's got a glass jaw.
I thought you were...
A big 6'8 heavy hitter. I thought he was going to get his fucking life ruined. But he has looked great in his last two fights. He knocked out Bigfoot.
Let's talk about that.
Now... As far as on camera, I looked great last week because I said, oh no, Arlovski's got a chance.
Yeah.
But off camera, I'm like, dude, he's getting his ass kicked.
Let's talk about that.
I was
so
wrong.
So listen.
Completely.
Arlovski comes out, right? And he is blasting Travis Brown. I mean, dude, just
boom.
I'm telling you, I can look you all on the camera. I can look at you. I can say that was one of the best heavyweight fights I think I've ever seen.
There's two things being said after the
I
fight.
Think I've ever seen.
They're saying it might be the best heavyweight fight of all time. All
right.
Which it's not.
I don't
if you include Pride, maybe best UFC heavyweight fight of all time. Even then, I mean...
I don't think it was the best of all time.
Yeah, off the top of my head, Couture, Hizo was awesome. There's a bunch of them. But Pride, like Nogueira, fucking Fedor, Nogueira, Bob Sapp, Nogueira, Heath Herr. Any fucking Nogueira fight was amazing in Pride.
Right. Right.
Even Krokop and Fedor was great. But there was a lot of great heavyweights. Pride had the heavyweights.
Right, and what was the second thing that they were saying after
the second thing was, it might be the best one-round fight that you've ever seen.
It was only one round, like Boone said. Arlovski comes out and is just swinging. And he's connecting, right? He's connecting. And Travis Brown is taking these punches, dude. I mean, he's hurt.
Ass kicking.
He's hurt, and he's wobbled.
Million times, you're like, how the fuck is he still standing?
I kept yelling into I marked out, dude. I marked out, right? So all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Travis Brown is getting
lit up,
right? Arlovski goes down, dude. Travis hits him.
Yeah.
Travis, I don't remember if it was an uppercut or a straight punch.
It was a counter, I don't know.
Whatever it was, it was a counter punch, dude. And Arlovski goes down. I said, yo, you gotta be fucking... Joe Rogan is going crazy.
Yeah.
I'm going crazy in my room. Arlovski gets back to his feet.
And within seconds...
Starts fucking knocking him again.
Knocks him out.
Within seconds.
The ref
stopped it.
Knockout, TKO, whatever.
Right.
I think he dropped him, and then the ref jumped in and was
the
like...
The ref jumped in and...
Oh, no, he didn't. He had him
had him on the ground.
No, I think he had him up against the cage, like, getting fucking worked over
just
like that. Just
killed.
Like,
right.
Right. Just, I mean, he was out.
And the ref jumped in and said,
There's no questioning
right.
the stoppage.
Right.
It was a very justified stoppage.
And it could have been stopped even earlier
there
than...
There were plenty of times where I was like, how the fuck is he letting him get the like
And the referee looked like he was about to jump in a couple of different times. I mean, he was letting it go, to his credit, dude.
You earn respect in the referee's eyes with certain fights. The Travis Brown, I think it was against Alistair Overstream, it was the same thing. He's up against the cage getting wrecked, and then he threw his big fucking foot out and
right.
just Overstream in the face
right.
and knocked him out and finished him. But he was getting his ass kicked before then. So fights like that happen, and the referee's like, well, if this guy's in trouble, I'm going to give him a chance because he's not done yet.
Right, right.
Whereas
right.
in a street fight, if you don't know the person, you're jumping, you know,
you're
breaking
jumping
it up.
You're stopping that
after
way
a
earlier.
Couple of those kind
right.
of points. What do you got on your chin? Is that a hair that's just longer than every
hair,
other hair?
I just did that too, man. That was... That,
you got it. It was like, no, it's under your chin now. I see what you mean about your chin. There you go. It just dropped.
All over the place here.
Yeah,
but
you do have
anyway.
A chin where, like, fuck, I was going like this. You got kind of a chin.
I got a real fat chin.
But anyways, it was the exact same fight that I seen in person.
Right.
Oddly enough, with Andre Arlovski and Tim Sylvia, their second fight, I was in Anaheim.
Well,
it was also Tito Ortiz, Forrest Griffin 1. Arlovski Sylvia 2 was the main event for the heavyweight title, and the exact same thing happened. Arlovski, but it was the opposite result. Arlovski was fucking, or no, I think it was, I don't remember the order. Basically, one of the two was lighting the other one up. Let's just say, for argument's sake, Arlovski was lighting Sylvia the fuck up.
Right.
And then, bam, Sylvia drops Arlovski. No, it was the other way around. Because I think Arlovski won the first one. Anyways, So Sylvia, Arlovsky's lighting Sylvia up. Or Sylvia's lighting Arlovsky up. And then out of nowhere, Arlovsky drops Sylvia. Oh, shit. Right. We're going nuts already from these big bombs landing. And then out of nowhere, the guy getting his ass kicked fucking land. Knocks the dude down. Whoa! Within seconds, Sylvia's back up and he drops Arlovsky. Gets on top of him. Boom, boom, boom. Arlovsky's dead.
Sylvia's a tough guy, too, man. A real tough dude.
He's
a
total jobber now. But back then, he was a big guy that hit hard. Which was exactly what Travis Brown is. Same height, even 6'8". I mean, it's the same fight, pretty much.
The other two fights weren't all... They didn't look
Weidman Belfort was great.
Robert Weidman Belfort
was a quick fight.
Right.
It was like a minute and a half, 2 minutes.
Right, right.
I mean, and it was the same thing. Weidman, or Belfort...
Listen, Belfort started off that fight. I thought Belfort was going to take it.
Yeah.
I was yelling to you. I said, I got this dude. Belfort's going to fuck. And then Weidman came back and died.
Knocked him down, got on top of him, finished him. Yeah.
Right.
And then the main event was basically Rumble landed like a really good shot on Cormier early.
Right.
And then the rest of it was Cormier dry humping him and then eventually
getting it was boring.
And eventually he got a choke, so we didn't have to sit through five rounds of it, thank God.
Right,
but,
right.
So that was the top three fights.
It was a boring fight. But anyway, well, the main event, it wasn't...
It was short enough that it wasn't like so ungodly boring where you're like, hurry up. Especially when you're doing play-by-play.
But overall, UFC 187 was pretty fucking good, man.
Top to bottom,
it was
amazing.
A pretty good show.
It was great.
All right. Now, we'll move on. Anything else UFC? Any big news? Anything that happened
there's
over the last...
There's some stuff. Nothing crazy. The Rousey thing.
We talked about Rousey.
Nothing major.
Alright.
There's a couple of stories. Nothing that we should be...
Nothing huge.
No.
Alright. TNA Impact Wrestling. So last Thursday night, we came on here. We gave you an exclusive. I said the article was going to go up on the website.
Oh,
you
real
know,
quick thing. Dana White said when Jones returns, John Jones, he immediately gets a title shot.
He loves some John Jones.
Oh, he admitted it. He was
loves
honest.
Some John Jones.
He said, listen, he's being punished. He got stripped. He's not even ranked anymore.
Didn't
he's taken
this,
off the rankings.
Didn't this already happen?
What?
He was punished for the cocaine and everything else.
He wasn't punished for the cocaine.
All right, but this whole cocaine thing happens, and it's in the past now, and then... This new thing happens, and cocaine is involved again.
It was one
and
of those,
now,
it accumulated.
And now when Jones comes back, he's in for a title shot. It's like, wait a minute, how many chances...
Well, that's what Dana said before he did all this. He said, listen, we after the cocaine thing, and the reason the cocaine thing flew...
What happens if he gets in trouble after this?
Oddly enough, the cocaine thing... It wasn't even against the Nevada Athletic Commission rules. They didn't have a cocaine policy. They didn't have one.
They
only steroids.
Testing.
Yeah, but they don't. Not for hard drugs. Just for performance enhancing drugs.
What about marijuana?
That's considered a performance enhancing drug, which is stupid, but it is. Not as bad as steroids.
So you're telling me if somebody takes heroin, cocaine,
I didn't
meth.
Say heroin or meth or anything. I don't know. I just know cocaine was not part of the rules. So they couldn't legally do anything because he got popped before the fight and they let the fight go on anyway because they didn't have a policy about cocaine. They didn't have anything. So after
you're
the
failing
fight,
a drug test.
You're failing a drug test, but it's not for performance-enhanced drugs. It's an athletic competition. The only thing they get in trouble for is anything where they're trying to cheat. And they don't consider cocaine cheating. Now they do. They've revised the policy and now it's in there and now the new suspension's 3 years first offense. They got harsh. And this just happened last week. But anyway,
a word on it. All right,
I promise you.
All right,
and that's why when you said didn't this happen with Tony's and the cocaine? No, the fight went on as planned. He won.
After
the fight, the results became public news. So then they had to try and do something. And he checked himself into a rehab, and then 24 hours later, checked himself out, and that was it. Done. Nothing happened to him. Nothing.
So what happens if it? If
so
he
now
comes
this
back
time, when the hit and run happened, and they found marijuana on the scene, the marijuana pipe, and he fled the scene, and it was a pregnant woman that was in. It was just a bad fucking thing. So they stripped him of the title. They took him off the rankings. He's got all the legal shit he's still dealing with. Who knows how that turns out? I don't even couldn't even guess. I'm assuming it won't be that bad, but it should be. But then again, Mayweather beat the shit out of his wife like 18 times, and he was still fighting every fucking 3 months or 5 months. But so the whole story was White said, yeah, when Jones returns, obviously he gets an immediate title shot. We punished him. I mean, we couldn't have punished him more.
Okay, what happens?
We did everything we could do.
Let me,
now
let me
it's
bring,
up to the courts to do the rest.
Let me say this.
We can't do that.
What happens if John Jones returns? He gets a title shot right back in a bit.
He wins.
What
yes,
happens?
He will.
What happens if he fucks up again?
It'll be bad.
It'll be bad.
Well, if it's a drug test failure, first of all, because of the UFC's new code of conduct policy and the...
I think he's fine leading up to a fight, and then after the fight's over, he feels like...
Give me an example of fucking up.
I'm going to go out...
What kind of fucking up?
I fight, I get my title shot, I go out and fight.
Oh, a drug test?
The fight is over. I don't have to fight for the next 6 months, three months.
Fight two or three times a year, that's
all right, I don't have to fight for the next 6 months. For those 6 months... I can go and party my face off.
No, you can't.
And I think
no,
John
can't.
Jones...
No, you can't. They have out-of-competition testing now.
Are they going to test them for cocaine?
Yes.
Okay.
That's what I was telling
That's
you.
That's the changes.
The Athletic Commission revised their policy. UFC has a brand new code of conduct, and they're both extreme. You fail for anything.
Okay.
You're out 2 years based on UFC's policy, three based on Nevada's, which is what UFC has to abide by.
Okay.
You fail for anything. You're out,
I think
you're out 3 years.
I think John
and
Jones...
And it's random out-of-competition drug testing. You don't know when you're getting drug... And they'll come at 2 in the morning
and
come to your house, take your blood, and make you piss.
I'm going to say this.
Randomly.
John Jones comes back, he gets his title shot. I guarantee you, within the next year and a half...
Don't just say fucks up. What does he do?
He fails the drug test for cocaine.
Wow.
He fails the drug test.
You think he's that bad of an act? And that's what's funny. There's a big rumor going around that he's a much bigger...
He's gonna try to sneak it.
There's a rumor...
He's going to go out and party and try to sneak it.
There's a rumor that spread that I helped spread several months ago when the cocaine thing happened with him.
That he's got a bigger problem
than people. He's got a much bigger problem than people think. So much so that once drug testers came to his gym... And he hit under the cage.
Right, I know.
He hit under the cage.
You told me this.
He laid under the cage until they left, and the coaches told him, "Nah, he went fucking somewhere. He's with his family or something."
He's, dude,
and that's the rumor that it's that bad, and he's lying about it, and he's like, you know,
you're gonna hear about John Jones. John Jones is gonna wind up getting fired from you.
He's really self destructive as shit.
He's gonna wind up getting fired.
That's the story. All right.
So listen, TNA Impact Wrestling. I'm gonna make this real quick, man, and then I want to get the rapid fire. I want to spend time on phone calls. We're going to open up the phone lines here in just a couple of minutes.
Yeah.
Let me get through the TNA, and then we're going to do rapid fire. We're going to give you a half an hour. I need 5 minutes. It's 9:25 Eastern time. I need 5 minutes for TNA Impact.
Can I take a nap while you're doing it?
You can. Go ahead. Please do.
I got to listen so I can respond.
TNA Impact Wrestling. We talked about it on Thursday night. Destination America officials. There were two representatives, very high-ranking officials from Destination America. They were down in Nashville, Tennessee, late last week, talked with Dixie Carter, talked with Billy Corgan, talked with John Gaborik, TNA's creative team. What can they do better to get these ratings up in TNA? Without outright saying that they were going to cancel Impact Wrestling, they made it very clear to TNA that needed to change. Ratings needed to be higher. The product needed to change. We need to improve this product. We need to get people tuned in.
One sentence.
Go ahead.
They've already made the decision to cancel TNA. They can't announce it publicly. So basically, it's up to TNA to change their mind.
They cannot.
They've got until September to change their mind.
So,
and then you go.
TNA officials were not notified that Destination America is not canceling Impact Wrestling, which is why Billy Corgan came out and said these rumors are false. They cannot tell TNA that we are canceling your product. Yeah. As of right now, come the fall, Destination America has every intention of canceling Impact Wrestling. Now, if ratings between now and the
TNA,
fall...
not just Impact.
Canceling
Impact
TNA.
Impact show. They're
Impact
everything.
Unlocked everything.
All of it.
If, by some wild chance...
Which is not going to happen.
Between now and the fall, the TNA Impact ratings increased like you would not believe...
Which they won't.
Then Destination America would reconsider as they've got a two-year contract... With TNA Wrestling.
Well, they still have trouble selling advertising, so it's...
I don't think that's going to happen. As, like Boone said, they're not able to sell the advertising
that all the network cares about.
They had wanted. They need to sell advertising to make a profit off Impact Wrestling.
Exactly.
They're not making a profit. It doesn't look like they're going to be able to sell more advertising.
When does that ever happen?
It doesn't look like, unless something drastically changes... Now,
everywhere.
Unless things drastically change between now and the fall, TNA Impact is going to be gone from the network. Now, why is Billy Corgan, why is John Gaborik, why are they coming out and denying this? They haven't been outright told by Destination America that we're canceling your product come this fall. Why haven't they been told? Because it's not supposed to have been out. because of two reasons. Number one, they don't want it out. It's supposed to be a secret. And there's TV contracts that they've got a 2-year deal with Impact Wrestling. So if word leaks out that they're canceling the product come the fall, they're in trouble. And word leaked out, and Destination America officials were.
Before you switch topic.
Whoa.
Are you going? More importantly, what you just said, they don't want word leaking out because they've got deals with advertisers already that have bought time on
the
show.
The advertisers find out.
When they find out they're paying for a show that's going to be fucking canceled in 2 months, they're like, well, I don't want to waste my money on a fucking show that nobody's watching that's going to be canceled. I'm not buying ads on this canceled piece of shit.
So
that's what's most important.
So here's the last thing. And there were people on my Facebook and in the comments saying, here we go again, Ryan shitting all over TNA.
Yeah, here we go again. And Spike turned out to be 100% true.
Ryan's
right.
Ryan wishing, you know, Dave Meltzer is the one that broke this story last week. And everybody jumped all over Dave Meltzer saying Meltzer's always wrong. This, that,
Bob Ryder, yeah.
All right, I can tell you, y'all said the same thing. Not all of you, but a lot of you said the same thing last year. When the reports came out that Spike TV was going to wind up dropping Impact
Wrestling.
Before
it was official, yeah.
Everybody said it's not the case.
TNA denying it.
TNA came out and denied.
Guess
denied,
why
right?
Denying it.
It's not happening. Yeah. It's not happening. You know why they denied it? Because they hadn't been told that they were going to be canceled by Spike TV. And then the announcement comes out on TMZ, I think, broke it. That said that Spike TV drops Impact Wrestling. They're gone from the network.
Well, they were also going to have trouble getting a new network.
But before this...
broke that they're a canceled show instead of we're just parting ways.
Before this, TNA said, it's not happening. We're not canceling them. Spike TV's not canceling them.
Good face on it publicly, yeah.
Good face, right?
Yeah.
And then, remember all the reports? They weren't talking to their talents. They weren't telling their talents anything about, no, we're fine
that
with Spike TV.
Yeah.
Everything's fine with Spike TV. The same thing is happening here. Talents, staff, they're not being notified.
It's literally the same thing.
And the fact that TNA,
yeah.
Dixie Carter, has not commented on the rumors. And let me ask you this. If the rumors were so false, why wouldn't Destination America immediately come out and outright deny we are not canceling Impact Wrestling? Why has Destination America, why have they not said a word? They haven't said anything about it. Why, when we've contacted them to get some sort of statement, why have they said it's not happening?
No comment.
Not even responding.
They don't say it's not happening.
They're not even responding.
The people they do talk to, no comment, and then except Meltzer got the scoop from somebody he knows.
There's no comment from Destination America. If it wasn't happening, or if there wasn't trouble, why wouldn't Destination America come out and outright say, and people say, well, Destination America, they don't need to say anything.
When the media
is all picking up on it, cable networks come out and issue statements that this is false.
Well,
this is not true. Yeah. And there's been nothing from Destination America.
That's usually done, you're lighting a cigarette, because of legalities. Like, if they had a quote, if Meltzer's story had a quote from an employee at Destination America,
right,
then legally they'd have to come out and deny it, because legally they're not supposed to be talking about this shit to anybody, let alone, not in public, let alone telling some reporter to go post this or whatever the fuck. If there was a quote or the report said Destination America has confirmed it, blah, blah, then they'd have to say, no, we didn't, blah, 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 you know, then they'd come out and deny it because legally they could get sued because they're not supposed to fucking say anything.
Right.
You know, the only reason they're not denying it is because it's just a quote-unquote rumor from a renegade reporter.
It's going to be the same thing like last year with Spike TV canceling Impact. All of these people say that
they denied it.
It's not true. It's not going to happen. Come the fall, all I can say to you, I can look you all right in the eye. Come the fall, let's see what happens in the fall. And if TNA is gone from Destination America, we'll talk then. You and I will talk then whether Destination America is still carrying TNA Impact Wrestling. Until then, they're going to be on Destination America until the fall. Let's see what happens there. And then... The last thing, I know I went a little bit longer than 5 minutes, but to the people that say I want TNA to fail. I want TNA to go out of business. Yeah. I come on here every single week, almost every single week, and I say that we need Ring of Honor. We need TNA Wrestling. We need Pro Wrestling Guerrilla. We need Pro Wrestling Syndicate. We need all of these companies to land.
We need Pro Wrestling Syndicate.
We need all of these companies to land television deals.
It's good for the business.
The more competition is better.
And it's places for people to work. You never make that point.
The more competition.
Hundreds of people have jobs because TNA's in business.
Absolutely. TNA goes out of business, all the talents lose their paycheck.
Production people.
Production staff. Not that they're being paid on time anyways. But
management.
And then you talk about talent. You talk about the production staff. You talk about
management.
Hey, if y'all didn't know, I own a website called TNA Wrestling News.
It would badly affect him.
TNAWrestlingNews.com. That website deals solely off TNA Wrestling.
One third of his business.
All right?
TNA.
I make a lot of money every month off TNAWrestlingNews.com. If TNA goes out of business, TNAWrestlingNews.com doesn't do me any good.
It could still do you good. I've taught you what to do with that.
Hold on. And I lose a lot of fucking money if TNA goes out of business. So the one guy that doesn't want TNA to go out of business is this guy right here.
You're not the only guy.
Because I lose a lot of fucking money. And all the other guys that run TNA websites, there's TNA Mecca and
Asylum.
TNA Insider, TNA Asylum, all those websites, they lose a lot of money too. So I'm losing a lot of money if TNA goes out of business, and that's a big fucking chunk of change coming out of my pocket.
You've already lost some money.
So
can't afford it.
And when I have to report stuff, I love putting positive stuff about TNA. I love
You're
it putting it on the website. Mm-hmm. But you know what? Sometimes there's negative stories that have to be reported, and it's not making stuff up. The Spike TV stuff.
The Spike TV stuff from last year.
Nobody wanted to hear that Spike TV was canceling Impact Wrestling.
Why are you rooting for them to fail, Ryan?
I'm making up false rumors. I'm rooting
I'm
for them to
fail.
You it's that and the other thing with Spike TV. And look what happened with Spike TV and TNA. They go to Destination America, telling you the same thing. Destination America, not happy with TNA. It's false. The reports are false. It's fake. You're making up shit. You want them to fail? Come the fall, let's see where we're at. But if TNA goes out of business, I need to rename TNAWrestlingNews.com to GFWWrestling.com.
That's stupid, because if they go out of business, you're screwed. That's a dumb comment. Big deal, you got plenty of other sites, Ryan. That's an ignorant comment.
Dude,
if
about $2,000average was taken out of your pocket every month, $2,000.
That's like saying
$2,000 times 12, if $24,000 a year was taken out of your pocket.
It's like
if TNA goes out of business and I lose TNAWrestlingNews.com and you lose $24,000 a year around there.
Yeah,
it's kind of a big deal.
It's like saying you've got $1 million in the bank and your friend stiffed you for $100,000. Oh, big deal. You got plenty of money. No, asshole. $100,000's a lot of money. What do you mean, big deal? You've got other money. It's a lot of fucking money.
I very rarely bring up how much I make on my website.
Most rich
people
do.
And I just did with TNAWrestlingNews.com, but that's a lot. That's a big fucking hit to my pocket.
Yes, it is.
And obviously, I would take that traffic and rename it to GFWWrestlingNews.com.
If you don't name it a generic name, you're an idiot. You're setting yourself up for it to happen all over again.
Right.
This was Jarrett's company, and it's going out of business.
I'd have to go to, like,
do a new Jarrett company.
IndieWrestlingNews.com or something like that.
Yeah.
I would have to come up with something different, or I could keep that traffic, but it wouldn't be based solely off TNA. And anybody that visits TNAWrestlingNews.com, if you've seen the post today, you've been seeing Ring of Honor posts, you've been seeing GFW posts, you've been seeing TNA posts.
Come on, guys, that's worked with TNA.
I'm trying to transition.
That's smart.
Right now,
by covering the logo,
by covering Ring of Honor, GFW, and TNA, I'm trying to transition that website into something else, as I feel come the fall, we're in big trouble as far as TNA is concerned.
You are.
All right. I am. I lose a lot of money.
There's so much confusion. I get it on my Facebook all the time. People really think I work for you. I do not work for you.
It kills me. It kills me when people say, here we go again.
Yeah.
Ryan wishing TNA goes out of business. Ryan wants
TNA. How did they come to that conclusion? Just because you post negative shit sometimes?
Because it's a negative TNA post, and anybody...
You're posting news.
Anybody that sees a negative post regarding TNA thinks that I'm trying to sabotage the company, and it couldn't be further from
it's like Jim Ross with the fucking Samoa Joe's contract thing. Like, he doesn't get... People don't get what we do sometimes.
It could not
we hear something
further than the truth,
we
man.
Share it.
Ugh.
We make sure it's true, and then we share it. That doesn't mean it's our opinion, or we're rooting for this, or we're trying to make it a bigger thing by posting about it. It's...
Alright. Load up those phone lines, brother. We have about 20 minutes to do rapid fire and live phone calls. So, we'll mix it up. We'll spend about 15 minutes on the rapid fire. And then, we will do live phone calls as well. If you guys want to call us... Oh, it's not bad. No doubt. If you guys want to call us live tonight, you can do so at 518-712... Hello?
3070.
Hello?
You didn't say the whole number yet.
518-712-3070. What's this? 3 2 1.
Well, there's a delay.
Oh yeah. 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. 3 2.
You're gonna look dumb.
1. We're on.
I know.
Where is she?
She might be taking a shit or something. Who knows?
A poop?
A poopies.
Here we go. Mike Butler, any truth to the rumors of the Wyatt family getting back together with Bo Dallas as well?
I didn't even hear that rumor, no.
I don't hear that rumor either.
The guy clearly hates the Wyatt family. Why are you spreading rumors, Mike Butler? No, I'm just kidding.
I have not heard that rumor at all, man.
That's a good guy.
Matt Johnson, why does it look different? Is something...
That's Windows Media Player behind it.
Alright. Matt Johnson.
He's talking to you.
With Clark dropping some hints tonight, will he finally propose to Boone?
And that got liked by somebody. Was it the same guy that... I want to see who liked it.
Man. Y'all...
Stephen Gabay. Man, these are two people I respect, too. Guys.
Y'all know that... Come on. You guys have been listening to us long enough to know that ain't nobody gay up in this bitch. Tom Nelson.
I don't know about all that, but I can tell you I'm not. Tom Nelson says, you're happy all the time. You're not gay?
I'm happy.
We'll
have
a gay all the time. Tom Nelson says, hey guys, I went to a WWE house show this past Saturday night, and Nikki Bella defended her title. My question is, when did she turn face? Because she got a decent to good pop when she came out. It feels like to me... The Bellas became faces, like, overnight. What do you think?
I don't remember Nikki Bella's pop from Raw last night. Was it a babyface pop?
They're working against Tamina and Naomi, and those are clearly the heels.
True.
So that makes them the faces by default.
True.
I don't think they've actually... Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. It wasn't a real babyface turn between...
Yeah, it was
very
opposite of how they normally
do it.
Normally they give people a reason, like, oh, she did this mean thing, like Nikki turning on Brie and making her give her smoothies and dumping them on her.
Right.
Then boo. Like, this was just like, oh, by default, who we're fighting, we hate them more than you, so...
Right, and like you said, Tamina and Naomi are clearly gonna be
you.
I don't know that our phone lines are working.
Sure they are.
Oh, I don't think so.
Here we go. Here's Jackie.
There she is.
Should we turn Jackie. The hair off?
No.
You can't
worry.
Hear it?
I can hear it. Jackie, what's going on tonight?
Nothing much. What's going on with you guys?
We are just doing a two-hour radio show on a Tuesday night. You know what I mean?
Yeah. There you are. Hold on a second,
Jackie. I gotta turn down. Oh, wait a minute. All right, there we go. We gotta turn the AC off as we can't hear the live phone callers tonight. But now we're good to go. So what's up, man?
What's on your mind?
What happened, man? Rusev, Lana, Ziggler?
I was watching Raw last night.
Mm-hmm.
I was hoping for reconciliation, but no. I believe that those two need a little time in couples therapy to work out their issues. I know that they're dating in real life, but I just can't stand this anymore. More, she was trying to make sure that he didn't. She was trying to keep him from getting hurt. I don't blame her for saying I quit on his behalf because he has a history of a neck injury. Everyone knows that. So he's gonna win the Intercontinental title. I see her turning on Ziggler this Sunday.
Turning on Ziggler already? Really? No, I think we're in for a long term. I mean, listen, they're still in the middle of the Rusev Lana. They're still in the middle of that breakup. So the fact that Lana just went with Ziggler, I mean, she's not going to turn on Ziggler already. I mean, I think there are big plans.
She's an alcoholic.
I think there are big plans for Lana going
it's
forward.
A work.
Yeah, I think there are big plans for Lana going forward.
There are.
And yeah, as we put up on the website, I mean, once she gets past the whole Rusev and Lana, which is what they're doing now, they're doing the split now. There are big plans for Lana now. Whether she stays with Ziggler or not remains to be seen. But I think that's just kind of a short term.
That's how to get her out of it.
That's kind of a short term type angle to get her out of. Right. Like Boone
transition
said, the transition
is what she's gonna become.
Right.
So what
exactly
happens is Vince becomes a fan of somebody, and then they get their career going up. They get taken seriously.
Right.
Like Mick Foley always said, I never thought I was gonna have a good career in WWE until Vince became a fan of mine. When I was doing the interview with JR that they split across 5 weeks, like when that happened, like all of a sudden Vince became like personally involved in my angles and stuff. Like he cared about my shit all of a sudden.
Right.
Whereas in the past it was just whatever the writers come up for, who cares? Just make sure Stone Cold's doing something cool.
Did you just mention Jericho, by the way?
Jericho-holic in the chat. He says it's a work because she says, why don't they get couples therapy?
But by the way, Jericho-holic or Jericho had his Twitter and Instagram hacked yesterday, and he went on today and he puts up a photo and he says, hackers, you want to try again? And he puts a photo of a middle finger up, right?
That's stupid.
The hackers got him again.
I was going to say.
The hackers got his Instagram. So he basically mocked the hackers saying, ha, I got my account back. What are you going to do now? And he put Jericho 2, hackers none. And then they went and hacked him again.
And it's actually 0-2 hackers.
They went they went and hacked him again tonight.
They got
and they changed the username on his Instagram. So then he goes on Twitter and he puts, hey at Instagram, they got me again, or it's happening again. Can you help me? So he's basically getting murked. And I think what's happening is
he's probably
Jericho,
got millions of followers. Why scare somebody?
Jericho
hey murderer,
probably,
right there, gonna shoot me.
Jericho is probably using a smartphone or something, and he probably went to a website that had a virus. And when you do that, the virus gets infected on your phone, so even if you get your password back or your account and your password back, you've still got that virus on your phone where he's being hacked.
Hey, gay rape person, I dare you. I'm going to walk around naked and bend over all the time. I dare you to do something. What do you expect? You're talking to millions of followers.
How do people hack into personal accounts?
Well, I mean, they're hacking his account, and then for him to basically say, hey, try again, I got my account back.
It's a personal attack. Like, the hackers, like, don't like him for a reason.
Yo, that happened to one of my friends last week. I'm not going to explain the details, but he had to go to court today to get the issue resolved.
Wow.
And
he had to go to court. Man.
Yeah, the person who did this is a former friend of ours. It's like, okay, you know what? I told my friend, change your Facebook password, and he did.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, anyways, Jackie, it was good talking to you this week, and you have a good week, and we'll talk to you next Tuesday night, all right?
All right, take it easy, guys.
All right, be good, Jackie. Good talking to you. All right, if you guys want to call us at 518-712-3070, 518-712-3070.
Real quick, let's get some callers this week.
I'm saying, let's go.
You're doing the generic thing.
I'm saying,
guys, we haven't heard from a lot of the fans in a while. We hear from Jackie every week, obviously. A couple of guys, some Stephen Grabea, give us a joke. Come on, call in and let's have some fun.
You know, let's do it
up a little bit.
Let's do it.
Do some
they all bitch
you. Yeah, we don't interact with them enough. We're call us. Well, say anything you want.
The callers that we get, they bitch about them. We don't bite. This guy may bite you.
No, I used to. I stopped doing that.
I don't bite.
I stopped doing that.
Call us up,
I'm
man.
Completely respectful.
All right, we left off
my
here.
God,
we'll go back
I let
to,
Jackie talk. Could you imagine what
you're
I
you're a mean
doing?
Guy when they call up, man. You're mean.
Would I not have ripped her a fucking new asshole 5 years ago?
We know her situation.
Anybody's. What do you think? I'm respectful of that. I'm
Ryan.
Just, I talk to callers now.
Ryan.
It's your turn. Go ahead.
Ryan.
Go ahead.
It's a good name, huh?
It's a great name.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You want to go get married?
Ryan shopped. Do you agree with Jim Ross' opinions on how TNA and Destination America have handled the rumors regarding the network and TNA? Let me say this.
I haven't really done anything yet.
Jim Ross basically said today in a blog that TNA and Dixie Carter were being irresponsible by not addressing the cancellation reports. Basically, there's been no communication whatsoever.
Mean publicly they're not addressing it, or to their staff?
To their talent and to their staff.
Okay.
They haven't said anything.
Okay.
Which kind of leaves the staff and the talent, you know, in the dark.
Yeah.
So he basically said they're being irresponsible, and I think he's absolutely correct.
I agree.
Yeah. Caller, you're live on WZR-TV. What's going on?
Hey, guys, it's Steven Gervais. How's it going?
What's up, brother?
What's up? Hey, what do you guys think about Kevin Owens? Do you think he has potential to be, like, main event star? What do you guys think?
I think so, man. I think so. I mean, let's just remember, it's like, you see these guys down in NXT, right? And they're over like Rover. Adam Rose, for example, was over like you wouldn't believe.
But
hold on. Was over like you wouldn't believe down in NXT.
Way.
I know, in a comedic way.
Yeah.
But they brought him up to the main roster in that same gimmick, and it failed miserably. Now, Kevin Owens.
Well, at best, he would have been a comedian.
I get it. But Kevin Owens is not a comedian.
No.
Sami Zayn's not a comedian. So, and Sami Zayn wound up getting hurt, so we don't know how far he can go.
Okay.
Neville. Look what they're doing with Neville. Neville was over huge. I think Neville's going to fall off, to be honest.
They're already starting to go down.
They're already starting to go down, right? I mean, they brought him up, but the guy can't talk.
You
got to
protect guys in bookings. They don't protect anyone.
The guy can't talk all that well, okay, as far as Neville is concerned. I don't think he can talk.
Yeah.
He cut a promo, what, two weeks ago?
I think he's cut one promo since
he's been
up. Yeah.
He can't talk all that good, and I think they're already going to sour on Neville. I thought Owens was great during his Raw debut with the microphone. Let's see what they do with Owen and Zayn, but
my thing with Owens is, can he get over as a main eventer based on his talent? Absolutely, he's that talented. The problem is, it's the Mick Foley factor. Will Vince get behind him?
Right.
You need Vince to champion your character.
Absolutely.
If he doesn't,
absolutely,
you're not going anywhere.
Right.
And I think because of his physique, which Vince is a fucking paranoid
freak
about.
He's
yeah.
a freak about it.
Because
right.
he's a little chubby, and he's a lot less chubby than he used to be, but, like, just because he's not he can't be a magazine model, you know what I mean? Like,
right.
Yeah, I think it'll be if he's so goddamn good that Vince can't deny it, maybe. Like, Bray Wyatt, I don't think Vince even looks at him as fat. He's so unique.
The thing that scares me is guys down in NXT are over like Rover. Like I said before, man, they're over big time. And then when they get called up to the main roster, I feel like Triple H is no longer in charge. Vince McMahon takes over. And
give
when
me an
Vince,
example.
When Vince takes over, when they come to the main roster, well, like Neville.
Because, like, the Shield, the Wyatt family were main event characters in NXT. And all right. But you're talking about comic characters.
No. There's,
come up
there's
and
some
be
examples. All right, Neville on the main roster gets called up, right? That's number one.
But they treated him seriously.
They treated him seriously, but then he cut that promo. And you even just said, not less than 2 minutes ago,
that's
that
why.
You thought
he didn't
they were
cut
already souring.
NXT very rarely.
They were already souring on Neville.
How many promos
did he
cut
in NXT?
They don't do a lot of promos in NXT.
Right? You just talked about Kevin Owens being called up to the main roster, thinking that he may be a little bit chubby.
He came in a late out John
Cena. May sour on him, right? So that's number two, right?
Yeah.
Number three, Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn comes up. Let's be honest.
He was injured.
Does Sami Zayn have the look that Vince McMahon is looking? He doesn't.
But
that's number three. All right. A lot of guys in NXT.
He's like a Chris Jericho.
A lot of guys in NXT, I think they're going
to
have it down in NXT. Triple H knows how to use them. But when they're called up to the main roster, I don't think Triple H, when they're called up to the main roster, Triple H doesn't
they don't
have
his protection anymore. Yeah.
Triple H doesn't have complete control
Correct.
Anymore. Vince McMahon. It's Vince McMahon.
That's
on
why
the main
I said
roster.
To answer his question. All right, the
let's go back to Steven. What I mean, we've been ranting and raving here. What do you think, bro?
I can't say anything tonight.
I am talking. Right?
No, brother. I think Owens. I think he's going to be all right. But I got to give you guys the joke of the week. All right.
So yes, Aaron, what do you got for us?
All right. How did Darth Vader know what Luke got him for Christmas?
I don't know. How does he know?
He felt his presence.
He felt his presence.
I don't get it.
I don't know Darth Vader.
I don't either. I've never watched Star Wars.
We don't get. You got to give us another one, dude.
Sorry. I'm sure it's great.
We don't want Star Wars.
He never watched Star Wars.
Look in the chat room. That's the joke. He felt his presence.
He felt his presence. He says this for the chat room. All right, because I don't know Star Wars.
I don't watch Star Wars, man.
Yeah, I couldn't tell you anything. Damn. I'm sorry, Stevie. I'm sure it was great.
Yo, let me get it.
What, because we had never seen the movie?
It was probably a great
job.
The chat's probably fucking dying here, dude. We're being idiots, dude.
Star Wars is maybe the biggest movie ever. We've never seen it, but...
Yo, I got one more.
Let me get it.
Here's a good one. What do you do with epileptic lettuce? You make a Caesar salad.
Instead of a Caesar salad, a Caesar.
Caesar.
I'll give you that one. All right.
That was
Stevie G.
Woo.
Anything else, man?
There we go. That's it, buddy. I kind of redeemed myself there at the end.
Thank you. You did a great job.
You were awesome, bro.
I love you.
Have a good night, man.
All right, guys, man. Have a good week.
All right, man.
You too.
I love that guy.
How's it going?
I love that guy.
He's always got something good.
I love that dude.
Yeah, even if he's googling it, he's doing great. Like everybody's laughing. He got the chat rolling. There you go. That's the audio.
Y'all
want to
call us? It's 518-712-3070. 518-712-3070. All right, let's get back to rapid fire. We've got. We left off with the Brian Shop Talk. I do agree with Jim Ross's opinions. Absolutely, man.
By the way, just real quick, we've only got one phone line. There was a lot of callers right there just now that we couldn't get to. I see them, but I can't take them until we hang up.
They were coming in like crazy a minute ago, but...
I can't take them until I hang up, so
y'all
I
didn't get through. Call back.
Just keep trying. So, where are we at, Stevie?
Stevie.
From the phone to the rapid fire. He says, I wanted to know, have you guys gone out on a date yet?
Oh, man.
We went to NXT last weekend.
They all got the gay
jokes.
Got the gay jokes from my fucking comment earlier, man.
You brought it on yourself. Was
it
NXT last weekend or the weekend before?
The 19th.
So last weekend. All right, so yeah, we went on a nice date to the Blasio Garcia Armory?
Washington Avenue
Armory. There you go. It was a great time.
Yeah? Caller.
We held hands, we kissed, everything, man.
No, we didn't do any of that.
Oh, okay.
Caller, you're live on WZR. What's up, man?
So, I have two things. I meant to call like a month ago, and I kind of just been watching and hadn't really called. So, the first one will be, there was a house show in Manchester, New Hampshire this weekend. I have a couple of buddies that went, and they had told me that, I should probably make Jackie happy there, Lana came out at the end with the John Cena vs. Rusev, and she low-blowed John Cena.
I heard that, man. I put that up on the website, man. Lana was helping Rusev out over the weekend, man. It was it's kind of weird to see, man. Lana
No. She started to help him at the live events, but eventually it ended with her leaving him hanging and walking off. Yeah. All
right. No doubt. All right.
So that's that one. The second one would be I went to a house show, not a WWE one, a big-time wrestling indie show there.
Okay.
And the NWO was there, Nash and Hall and Xbox.
Huh?
And so I got to meet them all. Scott Hall looked he looked all right, but at the end he went to go do the outside his edge on a manager or raise his edge whatever, and he couldn't even lift him up.
Yeah,
Kevin
dude.
Nash,
you know.
To help him the first time he
you know what?
Guy.
You know what, dude?
Again, so I'm just guessing he probably just doesn't have the strength anymore.
Yeah, man. You know what it was, dude? TMZ put up a video. About a week ago, and I don't know if it was at the same event that you were at, but TMZ put up that video, dude, where they were at like a fairgrounds or something like that. It was an outdoor type event, and they said Scott Hall had
kind of fallen off the wagon, dude, and they wound up kicking him out of the event, this, that, and the other thing.
And then after the show, he went back to DDP.
He went back. He immediately flew back to Atlanta, Georgia to be with DDP. So I know within
what's it called? The
accountability crib, yeah. But within the last month or so, man, Scott Hall's been in rough shape, and eventually
you're gonna relapse, dramatic.
Eventually wound up going back to DDP's crib down in Atlanta. So hopefully he gets, you know, back sober. But I think he fell off the wagon within the last month or so. So that's probably what that was all about.
It's too bad to hear that.
Yeah, man.
It is what it is.
Especially somebody that talented and cool and funny.
And they say they say that he's so good, like wrestling wise with creative.
They're trying to give him a job in NXT
and everything else, right? Hey, thanks for the call tonight, man. Appreciate it.
No problem.
All right, have a good night. All right, we got a couple more minutes here. 518-712-3070. Lance Winter, you see scam WWE's not got going. You see
what is
scam.
He saying?
You see the scam WWE's got going. May was free to new subscribers, promoting Elimination Chamber only on the net, with Elimination Chamber on the last day of the month. If you don't unsubscribe in 1 hour after the show, you are charged for the next month. That's a great point. They have Elimination Chamber on the final
So they're trying to hook people without them even
knowing
it. On the
final day. Now,
does it automatically roll over?
It automatically rolls over. Now.
So they position it in a way where, I got you.
In their defense, pay-per-views
and
air on a Sunday.
Yeah, and
they air on a Sunday. The last day of this month is a Sunday. It's the 31st.
I know exactly what
So, because it's a Sunday, it's the last day of the month. Yeah. That's in WWE's defense. Now, if you don't cancel,
in their defense, they scheduled it.
They scheduled it, but it is
their
a
defense.
Sunday.
They set it up that way.
It is a Sunday.
I got you.
Pay per view.
I get the whole thing
on
now.
Sunday.
Yeah.
Pay per view airs.
You got an hour. You're
Sunday.
Fucked. Yeah.
You got 1 hour.
You're gonna watch the show
after Elimination Chamber goes off the air at 11 o'clock Eastern time. Unless you're on the West Coast, you got a couple more hours.
So they're gonna end with a bomb. So hope you forget, and you're just like, oh, on WWE.com.
Well, hope you forget, and you'll be on Facebook, and you'll be on.
I mean, technically, couldn't the next day, even if they rolled over, couldn't you cancel and not have to pay for the full month? Or how does that work?
I think if you cancel on the first, you're still billed for that that whole month because
it makes sense. If you don't get it in time, it's your fault.
It's a smart move, but they're lucky.
But it's
they're lucky that the 31st falls on a Sunday for that.
It's smart short term. It's devastating long term. If you're starting to try and trick your fans into staying subscribers,
but who's gonna know that they were trying to trick you?
Obviously, when you wake up the next day and you're like, "Shit, I was not gonna renew." Now
I didn't
think
of it until Lance brought it up.
That's the point. They're doing it very sneakily.
Yeah.
So when people figure this out, like, "Oh, they're trying to trick us into renewing without us even trying."
Wait a minute. Yeah. All right. So in June, the last day of the month is on a Tuesday.
Yeah.
In July, it's on a Friday. In August, it's on a Monday.
Yes.
In September, it's on a Wednesday.
You better take my fucking calendar.
On October, it's on a Saturday. On November,
what's your point?
You could go on and on.
Do you think it's a coincidence that they have a free month and the last day is on a Sunday?
I know.
They picked the free month. They didn't even have Elimination Chamber on the schedule. They canceled it and replaced it with fucking what you call it. And they brought it back for this special Sunday.
It's a smart.
You think it's a coincidence that they brought it back?
It's a smart.
On a free month.
It's a smart but slimy move.
It's slimy. And then you do not want your fucking subscribers to catch wind. Or to come on, be wise to the fact that, they're trying to be sneaky.
I know.
Trying to trick us into staying members. Like, that's bad, man.
All right. Anthony Remy, Sunny Porn Update. It's happening.
Her Facebook says it's not.
You believe
of course it's happening. What are we even talking about this for?
It's happening.
Of course it's happening.
John Morgan.
Yeah. Where's he at? He says, if you're a TNA's top executives, how do you dig yourselves out of this hole you're stuck in? And get back to being a feasible ratings-drawing television program. How do you get out of this hole? It's probably too late.
You gotta draw those ratings. You gotta increase ratings. How are you gonna do that?
You got three TNA's or four months to...
TNA's product over the last couple of months has been much better. But how do you get people...
Sometimes it doesn't matter.
How do you get people to tune in?
Quality doesn't matter as much as business.
Yeah. Mike Butler, thoughts on WWE Shop? I was doing talking, and I pointed to the clock.
Yeah.
So you didn't even need to mention it right there. Mike Butler, thoughts on WWE?
What does that even mean? All right,
normally, when you're talking and I point to the clock, you say, where am I talking?
Yeah.
I was talking and pointed to the clock, basically saying, we need to hurry up.
You reminding yourself?
No, but I'm reminding us both that
I
got
what time
SmackDown.
It is. Read the next one. What are you doing?
Why did you make a reference?
Because I was trying to get my answer after yours.
You didn't need to make
the
reference.
You gave the answer.
Right there.
He gave the answer and then pointed to the clock like, all right, I've already answered it.
I was reading
the...
It
doesn't matter what you
I
say.
I said,
the next
Mike one. Butler, thoughts on WWE Shop taking down Hideo Itami and Becky Lynch's
I didn't read that.
Shirt.
I read the Lynch part.
Hideo Itami, there was a spelling mistake.
Is that what it was? They botched it? I didn't read the story.
There was a spelling mistake on the t-shirt. So, not sure about Becky Lynch.
Her said last liquor, or last kicker. I wrote it
that's
last
what
liquor.
It was.
And I guess that's controversial.
I thought it was
why,
too X-rated.
Yeah, I guess. Right. Do you think, Jason Hansen, do you think Andre Arlovsky should get the next title shot at the winner of Cain Velasquez and Fabrizio over Doom, or should he have another fight? Where would Stipe Miocic rank in the terms of the title contention? It's interesting, because Stipe fought Junior Dos Santos in his last fight, unless I'm forgetting of a fight. That's the last one I remember, man, and it was a war back and forth, very close, Junior won. So it's hard to give Stipe the title shot when he lost. What sucks is, here's the thing. In the UFC heavyweight division, there's Cain Velasquez, there's Junior Dos Santos, and then there's everyone else.
Uh-huh.
Cain's already beat Junior twice.
Yeah.
So you can't give Junior the fight again, but then you put Junior against the next best guy, Stipe, and he has a hard time with him, but wins the decision.
Uh-huh.
You're still not giving Junior the fight. Now, if Stipe had won, you're giving him the fight.
Mm-hmm.
So you got this Junior Dos Santos that can never get another title shot unless he just conquers the world.
Mm-hmm.
And he's eliminating all the contenders that can fight Cain and be like, wow, who's going to win?
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's bad. So Fabrizio Verdum is obviously number one contender. He's the interim champ. After that, Arlovsky, should he be next? I don't think so. I'd have to look at the rankings. But, I mean, the dude has put together a strength. He knocked out Bigfoot, knocked out Travis Brown. Those are two top 10 dudes. Brendan Schaub, I don't think, was a top 10 when he beat him, but even when he beat him, it was a boring fight. And he kind of, but Arlovsky's not far off.
John Morgan, when are you going to get Sonny on the phone to comment on these Vivid rumors? Hopefully we can get her on soon, huh?
I guess. I don't know.
Hopefully.
I mean, she's not going to say anything, obviously. She's denying it and then... You know what she's doing?
Yeah.
It's pretty smart on her part.
She's hyping it up.
She's lying and then telling the truth, lying, telling the truth, just keeping the story.
Keeping the story going.
And it ups her price.
Exactly.
For Vivid. Oh, look at all this attention we're getting. God,
exactly.
Six figures isn't enough. Now I want seven.
Exactly.
Bitch.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Vince Nugent, last week on Matt's Facebook page, Big Vito commented on, wow, I didn't even read this. What did he say? There's replies and everything.
I got a blog.
There's a couple of them right there. On one of the status regarding WZR TV being live on the air, will you guys interview Big Vito sometime in the near future? He said he wants to call you guys up for something. Your thoughts, fellas? And then
he wants to talk about the lawsuit.
We should have him on for that. He's got a reason to talk. We can have fun with you. Got this permanent I hate Big Vito thing. I think we should have him on. It'd be funny to listen to him. Oh, I deserve money because I'm a dressed guy and I did this and that.
It's all
I
here.
Think it would be fun.
I'll be right here, buddy. I'll be right here.
You need to rewatch the show.
I'll be right here.
I barely got anything even out of my mouth.
Right over here.
You asshole.
Right over here. I'm not talking about that.
Oh,
I'm saying.
You don't want to do the Vito.
If Vito comes on.
You really hit him that much? You can't have fun at his expense.
That's all you.
You can't have fun at his expense?
Bro, do you remember the whole thing between
you
and I? I can't do it.
That's what would make it brilliant. You bring him on like you're trying to have him promote his lawsuit thing, and then you subtly...
He's
it's like Stern. He brings Eric the Midget on before he died, and like all the time everybody's making fun of him.
You know what
he's
going to do? You know what he's going to do?
Yeah.
He's going to come on here, and he's just going to... Put himself
it'll be serious
over
Vito, though.
And over. And it's going to be
that's
serious.
That's the part
Vito.
That makes me...
And he's going to
yeah,
put...
Yeah.
And you can handle that. I can't...
No, I can't handle serious Vito.
I will
serious
sit,
Vito
I
is
will
boring.
Sit off to the side, dude.
Listen, he might be watching right now. And I'll tell you, I'll look you right in the camera if you're staring at me. And please don't come find me and beat me up. Although, I'm not that scared. But
you're boring when you're serious. You're fun and entertaining on the air. To me, we have different opinions on this. I've always thought Big Vito was amazing on the air. Because, partially because he doesn't understand why he's amazing. Like, he gets riffing and rapping and he thinks he's the shit. And it's funny to everybody that knows, like, God, is this Big Vito thinks he's the greatest wrestler of all time? Like, the guy that wore the dress for
he
a couple
really
months?
Thinks he's the greatest wrestler of
all
time.
It's not a put-on.
It's not.
He really, and that's
Big Vito. Big Vito thinks he is the greatest wrestler
yes.
of all time. He really does.
Not the greatest, but he really thinks he's more than what he is.
He thinks,
and that's what makes it fun on the air, because people are listening. And that's what I get scared. They don't know what we're doing sometimes. Like, well, Jackie, like, I can't get into specifics. But, well, Jackie, like, come on. Do you not know what we're doing for real with that? Come on.
I can't take him.
Stop it. Do you not understand what we're doing here?
You,
like,
wanna,
you think
you
we're
wanna,
that dumb we don't know what we're doing?
You want to interview...
Well, Jackie...
You want to interview Vito?
I would interview him, absolutely.
It's all you.
I would interview
him. It's all you.
If you book it, I will sit here and interview him. You can go take a shit. You can do whatever you want.
He's blocked on Facebook, Twitter, and everything else.
He's
I don't
not,
have a way...
Though.
I don't have a way to contact him.
What's this right here? Right there, what's that? On Thursday.
That's your account, not mine.
Oh, it is on Matt. Oh, it is on Matt. I thought that was yours. That's why I never responded. Now, Vito, I know you don't like him. I like Big Vito. I got to apologize if he's watching. I didn't know that was me. I thought that was yours when I was loading this up for you the other day.
I got him blocked on Twitter and
Facebook. I didn't know that.
I
didn't know that.
I want nothing to do with
the guy. I was loading the chat and the Facebook and the results and all that up for you the other day. I swore it because it said Ryan Clark.
Do you remember?
It says Ryan Clark right here, so I'm thinking I'm on your page. I didn't know he IM'd me that. I don't read anything on WCR on my work Facebook.
Listen.
My personal one I do. My fucking work one, I ignore everything.
I'm going to talk to him when we go off the air here tonight.
I would disagree with you.
Vito and I.
It's funny.
Uh-uh.
You had that in the past.
And something happened. Something happened that I'll talk to him about when we go out.
I know it.
That's your interview. That's your interview. You can do it on this show.
This happened before in the history of the show. You remember when we lived with your mom and you wouldn't fucking talk on the air because he was being a dickhead off the air to you? And you're like, you know what? I don't want to fucking talk to him.
You
I said, well, we got on the schedule. Like, I got to talk to him.
Yo,
you're like, well,
I'll
be sitting over here. You have the interview.
I will give you.
I'll do it.
I will give you the entire
ask
hour.
The fans if they want it.
You.
I don't need
and
an
Vito.
Hour. Give me
you
10 minutes.
And Vito.
15 minutes.
And there will be an empty seat right here. Hour number two, I will come in and do the rest
I'll
of the show
it if
with
you.
You.
Want.
I ain't coming on here with
I think
Vito.
It would be entertaining.
Fuck Vito.
Wow.
Jason Hansen.
Vito, I love you.
Thoughts on Steve Austin's new podcast on the WWE Network with Heyman.
That's right.
Which
he's
is
going to
be effing awesome
yeah,
next month.
That'll be a great one.
After
the next
all,
three
be
are
awesome.
Sting, Hulk Hogan, and The Undertaker are the next three.
They're going to be
for
awesome.
Austin. Those will all be great.
Going to be awesome after
Raw. Abe Ross, that's a new name.
There we go.
He says, thoughts on the Lucha Libre World Cup, and do you think that it's the only viable way to provide competition to WWE companies like TNA, ROH, Lucha Underground, New Japan Pro Wrestling, AAA, etc. working together?
I put the results up over the weekend. I didn't watch the show, and I know you didn't either.
There's Jay Mullen. That's the name we were saying earlier.
Jay Morgan!
Mullen.
Good to see you guys improve the show, but you continue to go off topic and drag it too long.
That's the point.
Along with cutting each other off, arguing like a married couple.
Oh,
well, that's the whole point
that's
of the show.
The show!
That's what we do, man!
I don't think they get it. So
anyways, for my question, I think they're booking Kevin Owens like the next Brock Lesnar. Could you imagine a match between those two? Booking Kevin Owens like the next Brock Lesnar?
They couldn't do that.
I don't know about that, man.
Brock's so much bigger than everybody that it's believable.
Take one of these two.
It's
from
a Nugent.
Vince and Nugent. One of the two.
Read the first one.
All right.
You want to read the next one again? What do you guys think about the... Oh, that's a dumb
that
question.
That sucks.
All right, Vincent Nugent. Take two. Any sort of update about the breach of contract lawsuit from Bischoff Hervey Entertainment between Eric Bischoff, Jason Hervey, and Garrett Bischoff against Total Nonstop Action Boys?
Yeah, it just came out last week.
We had it last week.
Eric Bischoff filed
a
lawsuit.
Very detailed. You'd have to go read it.
Yeah.
It would take 20, 30 minutes to cover it here, and we're already way over. WZRonline.com or TNAWrestlingNews.com.
For how much longer?
Hopefully a lot longer. He's got all the details over there. Go check it out.
There we go. Matt Boone! That,
yes.
My friend, is a Tuesday night, and I'm sorry.
We'll call that one Tuesday.
I cut you off a lot tonight, dude.
Yeah, I'll be honest
with you, man. I started drinking, at about 3 o'clock afternoon before I came on here. So I did cut him off a lot tonight, man. I didn't let him get
that's
a lot of words.
That's good though.
In,
it's good when you're passionate about stuff. That's when you're entertaining. Like sometimes I wonder if you even know when you're entertaining.
You called me out a couple different times tonight. Said I can't get a fucking word in with this guy. And there's been times where I felt
there's been times I do it every week. I just did it right now.
I felt the same about Boone tonight, but I did it to Boone tonight. So that's my bad for that.
We're gonna go get married over the weekend. We're gonna apologize to each other in bed, and then we're gonna come on the show.
We'll come back with our certificate.
We'll have our rings on, the whole works.
All right, we're out of here. We will see you guys. Submit your feedback, man.
I'm gonna post it this week. I keep forgetting
We talked about this at the beginning of the show tonight. Yeah. Like, people come on here and bitch that this ran too long, or y'all argue. That's the point of it.
This
is like my brother right here. Where we just argue all the time, whether we're on air or off air.
I've known the guy for almost 20 years. You're going to have arguments. But
I'm right. He's wrong.
There you go. But, whatever. But anyways, I haven't been doing the Facebook post for the last several weeks. But at the beginning of the show, it was like we even said, like, I don't think people fully understand what's going on here. And to mix with that, there'll be one guy that hates something. And
the rest love it.
Everyone loves it. Yeah. And it's like, well, I can't listen to you, sir, because you're the only one who feels that way. And, like, even if a couple of people feel some way, it's still a very small percentage. Like, I'll get emails. You know, there's Twitter.
Right.
It's hard to please everyone. So you just kind of got to do what you think's funny and entertaining and hope that the audience finds you, and that's what we're doing for 20 fucking years.
The same loyal people come back every week.
That's what I'm thinking.
We're doing something
right. They might be bitching, but there's got to be
something right.
There's got to be enough good within the two-hour span that they keep coming back. I mean, I don't think it's just like, oh, I like chatting with people for 2 hours. The chat room's open every day. You can go there every day. I mean,
that's Tuesday night, brother.
I can call that on Tuesday.
Right. He's an asshole. I'm the fucking man. For Matt Boone.
We didn't plug our Facebook, but that's me.
We should tell them how to submit feedback.
They might want to know where to go, yeah.
Yeah, they do need to know.
Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Facebook.com/RyanClarkWZR. Facebook.com. I'm going to post it tonight. Let me know what you think. Even if he doesn't listen to your thoughts, I'll just wedge him in because I don't give a fuck. Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. Facebook.com/MattBooneWZR. It will be up tonight, I promise. Let us know what you thought. We'll do more of it. Let us know what you liked. We'll do more of it. Let us know what you didn't like. Less of it. Facebook.com/something.
I wish I had like a microphone.
Right? Jake will have one in a minute.
Watch.
Yeah. For Matt Boone. That's me.
This is Ryan Clark.
Hey, that's him.
Saying see you next Tuesday night, 8-10 Eastern Time on WZRonline.com. Drop the mic.
Eddie Murphy, that motherfucker, man.